picture to my mom.
Smile.
You are watching the FM Senpai, the Bate Beast, Silando Escobar, a Minesweeper Champion, Geography Champion, and Streamer Showdown Champion, Vice Captain America himself, Zealand!
Ladies and gentlemen, now that we've set the mood, how are you guys doing today?
I hope you've had a good day so far. We've got a long day planned for you. I saw a couple people saying they're here for the first time. Somebody said they created their Twitch account just to be here. I just want you to know that means a lot. Welcome back to everybody, of course, that has been here before. Thank you to Callum for the 2 months. I just want you to congratulate you on being the first sub of the stream, subbing during the starting screen. Thank you so for that. We're gonna get a little bacon. Okay, there we go. You've created the button. What time is it there? It is 11:44 in the morning. So here's how today is going to work. Thank you so much for the Twitch Prime, by the way, Naps. Thank you for spending Jeff Bezos money. Thank you for burning the bacon. Oh, yes. How's the audio for everyone? Hopefully it's great. I heard that there might have been some chop. Can we confirm or deny? I need to know that now because it's an ongoing issue that apparently it just pops up at certain points and then we're fine for a long time, but then the chop comes back. Was there the chop in the audio today, chat? Please let me know. But the video's lagging. You can change the video settings. Bottom right corner, little settings wheel. The transition from the open to the stream was choppy. All right, Greed. Thank you. Confirming chop on transition. All right. So we've got the chop today. I hate the chop, dude. I hate it. I hate the chop. Ugh. So here's the plan for today. We're gonna stream. We're gonna stream until like 10 minutes before the Champions League kicks off. We're gonna raid over to James Lawrence Alcott's stream while I will be part of a round table where we will be watching the Champions League. I will be helping break it down.
Hey, Chop, FSU hate stream confirmed. Confirmed.
I don't hate FSU.
My brother goes to FSU.
But seriously, we're gonna stream up until the Champions League final. We're gonna raid over to James Lawrence Alcott. We're gonna watch it together. I'm gonna be part of the round table on that stream. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. He invited me to be on a couple of days ago, and I was like, absolutely yes. My pick at the beginning was either Manchester City or PSG at the beginning of the restart, so I'm gonna stick with that. But I will tell you, if I was betting money, like if I had to bet my mortgage, which I don't have a mortgage. If I had to bet my mortgage, I'd put it on Bayern. They're playing so well. But my pick from the beginning was PSG. I think this is the type of tournament they can win. And that's not like if they're used to playing in empty stadiums joke. I'm just saying that playing in empty stadiums is less pressure. And that's a team that's under a ton of pressure because it's Champions League or bust. And they're not even paying attention in league almost the time. Yako, thank you so much for the tier one. Welcome to the Hammers. Make sure you get to the subscriber section of the Discord. Thomas Isidro, thank you for the prime in the 2 months for spending those Bezos bucks. Dude, you know what it's about, Thomas Isidro. Thank you. And you're 1 month away from cooking your bacon. And Gostage, thank you for the prime. But huge bacon. Huge bacon. Huge bacon. From iNaps95i with the 5 gifted subs, dude. 5 new hammers. iNaps just joined the Hammers like 3 minutes ago. Came in with a 5 gifted subs. Yuke Nukem, Something Conflict, D Coop, Lord Brodovich, and Christy MC. Welcome to the Hammers. Be sure to thank Naps. And if you've just joined the Hammers because of Naps, because of Tim Spirit with the gifted sub, the 5th in Tim Spirit's career, well, we need some bacon. That's too fun. Oh. Wild Shroom, you're in the Hammers as well. Tim, thank you so much. iNaps, thank you. A pile. Hype train on to level 3. If you just joined the Hammers out of the kindness of others or the kindness of yourself in a treat yourself sort of Sunday, make sure you get into the subscriber section of the Discord for competitions. I actually just recorded a video where I went into the subscriber section of the Discord. I posted in the Hammer chat. I said, hey, if you have any questions you want to ask me about streaming or YouTube or whatever, I'm gonna do a video where I just answer your questions. And we got like 40 questions in 10 minutes. It was great. And that's the sort of stuff you get to do when you're in the subscriber section of the Discord. So very nice, much vibes. A lot of
Kelvin.
Well, not a lot of that. Did we? We need that, man. Finally free to watch on YouTube for those who don't know. The final, yes. The Champions League final is free to watch on YouTube. That is the stream we will be watching for the round table since we can watch it everywhere. All right, that's it. I'm new at FM. Do you think Bate is good to get knowledge of the game? Yeah, not the easiest. I'd recommend like Celtic. Bate is not a super hard team to have success with. But like Celtic, Dynamo Zagreb in Croatia, those teams are probably the easiest to have success with off the top. Can we get some bacon? Boom. Let's get over to Genetos, shall we? We got some matches that we want to play today. We've got some important tones we want to set. Thank you to the anonymous gifter, to T-Drug. T-Drug, welcome to the Hammers. First save is Liverpool, and I drew Real Madrid, Leon, and Inter in the Champions League group. That's pretty brutal. Hey. How did you start your sports broadcasting career? I want to be one myself. So how did you start your sports broadcasting career? I want to be one. Matt, the first thing I would do is get yourself in front of people. Let's see what Chiss has to say.
Less than 3, thank you for all the great videos and helpful tips, Zealand. Your humor is right up my alley. Less than 3.
Right up! Thank you for the 500 bits, Chiss, and that means a lot. I'm glad it's so effective. Itchy Poet, thank you for continuing your gifted sub bacon. And Yuke! Oh, come on.
Let's go Fernando Alonso for the triple crown.
Yug, quite the hype train we've got open in the stream today, dude. I'll get Matt, I'll get back to your question in a second. Yuk, 17? 17. 17 months from Mod the Yukula. God, has it been that long? I think you came over from like a Loki Doki raid very soon after I started doing this and just stayed. Let's simp for
Zealand. What? Simp for Zealand.
Damn, dude. Okay. If I have to, I mean, I'm not going to fight it. Not going to fight it. Sounds like something I'd want to do anyways. God, what a phase we're in. What a phase we're in, chat. Phase. Thank you, Yuke, for these 17 months. You're amazing. Itchy Poet, thank you again for continuing your gifted sub. Wanting to continue to be part of the Hammers after the 1 month you got from the mom bot. Will you ever get a YouTube series? I'll tell you what does exist right now. It now exists. Let's go over to the YouTube here. Let's go to Zealand Live. You know? It doesn't pop up yet. This is what confused. I only have one video on it, and it doesn't pop up yet. It makes me sad. Let me switch over to a little Zealand Live action. Go to this channel. This is the live channel. If you ever miss a stream, you want to keep up with the stream saves, this is where you go. Thank you guys for the level 3 hype train. Yes. Live channel. I'll post a link since it's apparently impossible to find. But at some point, it will not be impossible to find. Alas, it has just begun. This is... Oh, Mombot! Holy Moses! With a lot of...
Bacon!
That's just a lot of...
Bacon!
I think. That's the... Oh, we have a VOD thing. Yes. That's the brilliant. Well done, gentlemen. We have a VOD link, exclamation point VOD, live channel. Every stream, whether it's a save or not, will be uploaded there, hopefully within 24 hours, definitely within 48 hours of the stream. It's there, Swerving Spade, I love you too. Mombot, speaking of the love, with the 5 gifted subs, second batch of the fiver today, caffeinated happiness, sliving, Noah, Daloscar and Mingos. Welcome to the Hammers. You've been gifted a free sub. Got any suggestions on a league to manage in that doesn't have many player restrictions like the English work permits? Poland has none. Germany has the same as the Champions League, and that's it. So it's really easy. It's on both. It's on. I'm not deleting them from Twitch. I just want to make them more easily accessible. Villy Q, thank you for the 2. Let's go, Bayern. Freak, what the PSG and Tuchel, Rory, me with the 3, Bacon, damn dude, 3 on a 3-month streak, just get right in there, huh? Servalor, you guys are popping off today. Servalor with the 2 gifted subs. Servalor, hey. Anyone else here from Hull, England? Probably, yes. Servalor, thank you for gifting the 2 subs, doubling your amount of gifted subs ever, including some more people in the Hammers. Fanti and Scrabble can trace their lineage back to you. Welcome to the Hammers, Fanti and Scrabble. Get in. Who are you supporting the Champions League final? PSG. So to go back to what Matt was asking. How do you become a sports broadcaster? First thing you need to do is you need to get yourself into that situation where you can call as many games as possible. I'd recommend buying 2K, Madden, and FIFA if you want to do soccer, right? And then you turn the announcers off, do it yourself. Play a career mode, call every game, right? Just get comfortable talking. It helps with your multitasking because obviously you're also playing the game, right? That's how you get basic reps in. For me, that's how you get basic reps in. It's the most easily accessible trove of storylines and games, and you know the players, and just go on and call the games. The other half of it is getting yourself in front of people. And so the way to do that is to volunteer just to do stuff. I don't know what stage in your career you're already at, but when I was like 14, I was spotting for USF, University of South Florida, American football, baseball, stuff like that. I was doing spotting. And then by the time I was 15, I was doing a scoreboard for the minor league team. So you just send emails. It's definitely not going to happen if you don't ask. You said, hey, can I shadow for a game? I'm super, like, I just really want to do sports broadcasting, but I would love, you know, school project, whatever. I would love to shadow for a game. And then while you're there, hey, is there anything that I could do? You know, I'll make it an internship. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Like, yeah, depending on what level of life and your career you're at, you can skip that step or not. But be sure to vote in the poll. Who do you think is going to win the Champions League up at the top? Bayern's getting all the love right now, but honestly, I think PSG is going to win. I mean that honestly. Have you decided the new schedule yet? Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? I need to check my phone to make sure it's like absolutely dead on. But have you decided the new schedule yet? Yes. You ready? The new stream schedule. The new stream schedule is... I'm going to enter it. I'm literally going to enter it on Twitch while we're having this conversation. Because I need to do that anyways. The new stream... I actually already have... Was anybody paying attention? I already entered the schedule on Twitch. Tuesday at 3:30. I didn't. Can I edit this? Tuesday, 3:30. This end time is... On Tuesday, it's pretty hard set. I got to get off at 7:30. Okay, but Tuesday's 3:30 to 7:30. Because I literally have a class I have to go to at 8. So I got to get off at 7:30. This is New York time. So 5 hours ahead for London time, which would be 8:30 p.m. Okay? To 12:30 p.m. on Tuesday. Every other day, not as much. And I am missing a day, I promise. I'm streaming 4 days a week, just like normal. Thursday, 3:30 to whenever. I put 8:30 because it makes you put an end time. 3:30 to whenever on Thursday. So 8:30 p.m. to whenever. But it's almost a weekend, doesn't matter. And then I'm now a weekend streamer, chat. Weekend streamer. Kamal Tirta, thank you so much for continuing your gifted sub. I really, really appreciate that. Welcome everybody to just joining in the stream today. Reed, thank you for gifting Parfait a sub. Bacon, I appreciate that, Reed. 68 gifted subs to the channel, you absolute beast. And then I become a weekend streamer. So we've got Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday. Zaylin, when are you streaming on Saturday? How do I add? I don't. Okay, add stream. Saturday. Let's make it 4 hours. We start at 11. It's Saturday and Sunday at 11. So that's what we got. These are the streams. I don't know why I don't like listing games. It makes me feel weird. I'll usually be playing Football Manager, obviously. So Tuesday's like hard coded 3:30 to 7:30, right? And then Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday, unless otherwise posted, these might move around, right? But I imagine you usually, time wise, they'll be at some point during that day, but like, they'll be there. All right, Parfait. Catch the sleep. Congratulations on getting the sub. Thank you to Reed for gifting it to you. This new schedule is freaking good for me. So how's this look? How does this look for you? When's FM Showdown next week? How does this look for you? Looks stinky. Oh, dude, I'm sorry to hear that. Well, Stewie, I'll be streaming this time, though. Like, this time. The next couple months. How do you change to stray time? Backwards 10 hours? So, like, backwards 10 hours is 1 a.m. here. Like, is it 1:45 there? If so, then I'm right. I'm pretty sure it's backwards 10 hours and forwards a day. I think that's what it is. But that's it. Next Saturday and Sunday will start later because the Streamer Showdown. Well, that's true. I mean, we just got Streamer Showdown, baby. We'll probably start like an hour and a half late and do Streamer Showdown prep and stuff on stream. Because I know people find that really interesting to watch. So here's what's annoying. So like the Stream Elements thing has its own schedule. I've got to change that too. Saturday, Sunday at 11, Tuesday. Somebody already changed it? That's amazing. Or did I change it myself and I forgot? I will do my absolute best to be here and live at these times. Boom. All right, it's all set. That's our schedule. I really do hope it works out for you. That's when I'm able to stream. That's when we're able to clown and have some fun. Bayern with 78% of the vote, chat. You guys are really on the Bayern train. Look, all I'm saying is the best player in this game is Neymar. And when you have the best player, you have a chance. Not the best team. They have the best player. And Lewandowski, look. He should win the Ballon d'Or if they had it this year. I feel terrible that he's not. Neymar's better than him. Neymar has an it factor when he's on that obviously Lewandowski does not have in terms of his ability to pick the ball up deep and go on a rampaging run that just completely ruins a day for somebody. You know what I mean, right? You totally know what I mean. Mostaf, thank you so much. Bacon! Lewandowski is much better than Neymar. That's an impossible argument to make. The argument that Lewandowski is better than Neymar is a possible argument to make. Lewandowski's had a better season. He is a better goal scorer. Neymar is more talented than Lewandowski. Lewandowski is one of the five best players in the world. Neymar is one of the best three. To me. Neymar is the type of player that can completely ruin a game. A game plan and anything, right? You get what I mean? Yeah. Lewandowski's the smartest player. I'm not saying Neymar is smart. I'm saying Neymar can handle pressure. He says no. Like, I love Lewandowski. I'm a Lewandowski truther. I want him to win the Ballon d'Or this year. I love him. But Neymar's more talented. And they both, I mean, Neymar can handle pressure like nobody's business. We're talking in real life. We're talking Champions League final today. Kevin De Bruyne is the best player Kevin De Bruyne is the best midfielder in the world. Who are your top three players currently? Oh boy. It's Messi and Neymar. I almost said Gareth Bale for the memes, but I'll spare you that. I do love Gareth Bale. I still think Gareth Bale is one of the 30, 40 best players in the world when he wants to be. Problem is he doesn't want to be. I still think he has it in his locker right now. He's definitely healthy because he doesn't play anymore. That's an argument for a different time. Look, it's Mbappe. Mbappe's the third, and I was debating not saying that, okay? I was debating not saying that. I really wanted to say Ronaldo because I know the debate we're about to get in, chat. I know the debate we're about to get in, okay? Three best players in the world are Mbappe, Neymar, and Messi, and Messi is by far the best. Ronaldo, if you remove penalties from his season, it was not a normal Ronaldo season. Ronaldo is one of, if not the best player in the history of the sport. He's starting to get old a little bit. Right? He's starting to get old a little bit. Bale playing for Wales versus Bale playing for Madrid's a different level. Well, I think when you watch Gareth Bale play for Wales, and this is, we're going to be having multiple debates at the same time. When you watch Gareth Bale play for Wales, that to me is like, That is what Gareth Bale is capable of. When he's got the backing of the team, he's given the opportunity to do what he does best. I'm just saying, look at the analytics. I love analytics. Because he entered Juventus? No, I just think he had a bad year. For him. He had a bad year. You know who didn't? Mbappe. If you look at the analytics, Mbappe is the best player in the world. I don't believe... That's why the analytics can't be alone, like, king. Because we all know Messi's the most talented player in the world. Right now. Messi's the most talented player in the world. If you look at the analytics, Mbappe is. Ronaldo isn't there. What about Pulisic? Look, I love Pulisic, but I'm not that much of a fanboy. Come on. Come on. If Bale does go to Spurs, as it's rumored, he'd be a great super... Oh, shoot, man. Super sub. Put Bale in the starting 11, man. Surely De Bruyne has to be top three over Neymar. Look, I love De Bruyne. He's the best midfielder in the world. De Bruyne is my favorite player. De Bruyne is my favorite player to watch. He's Mr. Fundamental. He does everything right. He's decisive. God, he's decisive. Like, I don't like Neymar. He flops. He's annoying. I think he's a huge prick. And I think the vast majority of us could agree with that. There is simply no denying the fact that since Neymar was 6 years old, he's had the weight of his world, the weight of the world on his shoulders. He was the second coming, and he delivered on it. All those things are true. He's a prick. He flops all the time. His family is weird. Did you see the flick in the semifinal? There are two players in the world that can make that play. Him and the greatest player probably of all time, which is Messi. I don't feel like I'm educated enough on footballing history to be able to make that statement for sure. But probably the best player of all time. In terms of what he can do on the ball. Messi and Ronaldo are B-Tech Pulisics. Dude! Pele, I mean, like, Pele obviously inflated his stats. So it's like, who's the best footballer ever? I'll say Pele, because what are you trying to do? What is the point of the sport? The point of the sport is to win. He won more. Like, you can't fake winning. You can fake how many goals you scored. You can't fake winning. Can you please do a hard save and try and get him promoted back to the top? Like, you guys got relegated? Dude, that sucks. I'm so sorry, Yassi. Pulisic's better than Pele. Yeah, I love the amount of Pulisic fanboys we have. We need to keep this energy all the time. Because I am all here for it. I want to be a Pulisic fanboy. I want that to be my profession. Darmus is still hurt, right? Yeah. What do you do for a living? I'm a Pulisic fan. Oh. I hear that pays well these days. Absolutely. Think Maradona. Well, the Maradona Pele debate is the Argentina or Brazil. Who do you like more? Or the clean cut guy, or the guy who's like completely disheveled, just love of the game. Well, yeah, I hate the football. I hate that the sport is. I hate the argument. Lingardinho is better. Okay, you're welcome here. Lingardinho truthers are welcome here. You guys understand the point I'm making about Neymar, though, right? Like, Lewandowski, to me, you expand that out. And it's like, then you have Lewandowski right there. And probably De Bruyne. Top five. Yedlin better than Pulisic. He's faster. I hate the argument, like... You go, oh, well, if you go and, you get those guys. Well, if you go watch Pele play, right? And if you took Pele off the field at the World Cup and you put him on the field at the World Cup today, he'd be the worst player on the field. He'd get embarrassed. He doesn't have the tactical quality. You know, this is unbelievable. Like, how could you say he's the best player ever when clearly, right, he wouldn't be able to play in the modern Champions League. You get those guys, right? Here's how you deal with those guys, right? And this is a take that I used to go for until somebody made this argument to me. If you took Pele, right? If you took Pele and you put him right now, that, like, you just grabbed Pele at 10 years old, right? Whenever you think development really starts as a player, and you put him in the Manchester City Academy. Are you telling me he wouldn't be absolutely disgusting? Because when you're back in those days, there wasn't a flat field in sight. Comparatively, there were no flat field. Like, the pitch is terrible. The training back then, the accepted method of training was to sit at halftime and smoke a cigarette. I just picked a club with all the money that money could buy, right? That's true. The ball was different. The goal was different, right? Like, the understanding of fitness and, like, muscles and tendons and fit, like, staying healthy and being able to get the best out of your body was at such a level that you had actually have a beer at halftime. You're like, and he, the point is that given the circumstances around a guy like Pele who played eons ago, he was playing grown men who were all trying to win. They all really wanted to win. And you know who actually won? Pele. Given all those circumstances, he beat all of them. This is an art for every sport that goes way back in history, like basketball in the United States goes way back in history. So when you go, well, this guy scored 40 points a game, like, but could he do it today? I'm like, well, if you took him and put him in the freaky, like, if he got modern training, modern medicine, like, he would, there's just something up here. To be an athlete that is that good, there is something up here that allows you to do it. There are certain people that you know, I am not one of them, that are just great athletes, whether they're playing poker, whether they're playing, like, water polo, like, they're just great at. With your Pele, I'm assuming that we all kind of understand is that dude's just a great athlete, was on 12 out of 10. And so you take him and put him in a modern academy, he's still amazing. Calandra, thank you so much for the 2 months. Thank you for spending your Bezos bucks here. Welcome back to the Hammers. We've got our first match to play, actually. Mbappe braced today. Wilt wouldn't average... No, I'm not saying Wilt would average 50 today. I'm just saying that they would still be great. The argument is, could players these days play back then? I mean, yeah. I think, well, here's the issue. Messi wouldn't have gotten growth hormone. So if you take Messi back and put him in the 60s, I don't think he ever amounts to anything because he's 5'4". I think we'd see Ronaldo and Messi see play every week, every game, every 8-2 loss. Pele didn't get broadcasted worldwide. You only see and hear about the highlights and his accomplishments. Yeah, but he won more World Cups than anybody else. This is like, that's the thing. Pele can't play in modern football, though. Well, the whole point, Plaster, is that obviously if you took Pele in the 60s and put him in the World Cup, he's literally the worst player at the World Cup now. But the point is, in those times, with that training and that understanding of fitness and that stage of the game, he was the best and everybody was still trying. So if you take 10-year-old him and put him in an academy here, all the advantages that he has, that Gabby Jesus has to be able to still not score, right? Sorry, Gabby, I keep picking on you. And that's it. Tiki Kalula, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime as well. The love is strong. Thank you for spending Jeff Bezos' money to be part of the Hammers. That is what it's all about. Make sure you get in the subscriber section of the Discord and everything else. Auntie Anson, how you doing? I wish Ronaldinho was more professional. He would have been the GOAT for sure. I mean, you can always say that, but that's, you either have it or you don't. I think there can be events in your life where you learn how to be a professional, but that what makes Tom Brady great? We sure as hell isn't fast, right? Why was Tom Brady able to play for 24 years? Right? Why is Zlatan able to play really well at 38? Because they don't care about anything else. They wake up every morning like, what kale shakes can I drink in order to keep playing. The main argument against Pelé is that he was playing against lower quality players. Yeah, he had, there's a lower bar. It's a lower bar, but he was also subject to the lower bar. Pelé didn't have a lot of the advantages that Ronaldo and CR, you know, in Messi had coming up to train, to be better. Pelé made some erectile dysfunction commercials, and you know what? I bet he got paid a lot of money for it. Joshy G!
Bacon!
Thank you so much, the Twitch Prime sub. Or it's like gaming Amazon, Amazon Forest Prime something. Hey! Hey! What is it? You were looking the wrong way, you idiot! Oh! What is it? It's Amazon, it's Amazon Gaming, I think. Okay. Love you, bud. Let's play a game. He's going the, oh no.
He's going the wrong way. Let's look at the wrong way.
Tom Brady, best football of all time. Johan Cruyff, I mean, here's the thing. You know anything about the NBA, and I'm thinking about making a video where I compare NBA players to soccer players, to footballers in the past and the present. Larry Bird is a great player. Johan Cruyff is a great player. Michael Jordan's the best player ever. There's one last step, right? One last step. And it might not even be on the field. The step might be in the minds of everybody else. Like, do I think Michael Jordan going one-on-one against Larry Bird would win? I don't know. But there's that one last step, and it's the mystique of the player that makes them the best ever. That's what Pelé has. Maradona has it. To be able to contest, right? Messi and Ronaldo have it. Larry Bird, Johan Cruyff. They don't really. But the, you know, their names are hallowed ground. They are they're unimpeachably a great. Craziest thing you've ever seen happen in FM. My goalkeeper punt the ball off the back of my center back's head into my own net. Hey, you know, classic normal things. But Joshy G. Hey, Joshy, you cooked your bacon. Shoot, dude. And most stuff, I know I referenced it quickly, but thank you for the 4 months. Gambling, that was good. Then how can LeBron defeat Jordan? Jordan's the GOAT. He won 6 titles. Do you follow an NBA team? Not really. Cruyff never won a World Cup. Exactly. It's just like unimpeachable great. Not the best ever. Shoot! Let's go. Brian Galvan, man. He eats chumps like you for breakfast, you hear? Brian Galvan eats chumps like you for breakfast. Let's go. God, when he's on, when Brian Galvan is on, he scores the best goals our team scores. Huh. Giroud's won a World Cup. Doesn't make him better than Messi. No, it doesn't. You know why? Because Giroud wasn't the best player on the World Cup team. He didn't score. Right? If you want to start making the argument that Mbappe is better than Messi 10 years down the line, you can look back at that World Cup team and be like, you know. Hey, disclaimer, thank you so much for the Prime. Can we get
bacon?
Can we get some some
bacon?
That's those 2 months from Disclaimer 89 with Jeff Bezos money, which is it's just exactly how you're supposed to do it. Oh, who got hurt? No. I don't have a sub for this.
We don't have a sub for this.
Let's get weird. So the actual sub is Marrero out for a center back, and then we just we move everybody else around. That's kind of funny. I suppose with a 1-0 lead, we can bring the right wing back a little bit. But Giroud is better than Messi. I can't help you at that point. I think you need counseling. I don't think there's anything left for me to do. Is a World Cup the prerequisite to be considered the best player ever? This is a very important conversation to have. I think Pele is the best player ever, right? And I don't think it's because of the stats. I think it's because of the winning, right? That's why Michael Jordan's the best player ever, because he won 6 titles. He never lost in a final. Right? So I like Jared Bowen. He's good. Okay? That's the Villa fullback, right? I like him. Good work rate. Opponent's order, thank you for the 2. Loving the content. Let's go, Genetos. That's the freaking spirit. And thank you for the 2 as well, Gladitron, with the Twitch Prime. Hell to the yes, brother. Hell yes. The shakes and the bake. The shimmies and the shakes. You guys are both 1 month away from cooking your bacon. I hope you're, are you already planning the festivities? Any tips on making money in Wales? Yeah, you just got to get in Europe. Getting one European paycheck pays your budget in Wales for like 3 years. Just get into Europe and win one game with a bunch of lone players from England, right? It all ties back to Giroud. You're right. I'm an absolute fool. Hoagie, thank you for the 2 months of the Prime as well. Is it Hoagie? Hoagie, the triple sixes. Thank you for spending Bezos money to be part of the Hammers for a second month. It's all free. You just have to spend Jeff Bezos money if you got that fancy, fancy Twitch Prime. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here with this trash. We played a really composed game. We gave up one chance. We saved it. That's what we do with the high line. That's fine. Probably should we shift off that on like 75. So we got what, 10 minutes, and then we'll start phasing into our more defensive setup. Oh, what a ball by Galvan. Oh, he hit the post. Oh, he hit the post, Chad. Dude, I'm pretty sure that's... Jordan had a better team than LeBron? Yeah, he did. Well, at some points. I mean, I think Anthony Davis might be better than Scottie Pippen. That's a different conversation. Jared Bowen's who, dude, I'm so confused. Jared Bowen's that dude, right? Yeah. West Ham. Fuck, same color. Mother dude. Same color scheme got me all crossed. I'm so sorry. They both stayed up too. I remember he was on a team that stayed up that had that color scheme, and damn it, there were 2 of them. I mean, the color scheme might be slightly different, but to my American eyes, 69-420, I'm very sorry. But yeah, I do like the guy. Remember, I watched him a lot down the stretch. Pele was by, what do you think, Garincho was the best player at those World Cups? I mean, Pele was very, you know, not maybe not at every World Cup he was at, the majority. It's all about winning. Thoughts on Dan Marino? Is it at least an unimpeachable great? He's not the best quarterback of all time. Who is? Tom Brady's got like 25 Super Bowls. Right? But it's the same conversation. What do you think of Messi leaving Barca? I think it's like not... I missed a personalized message. I did, probably. You guys have been insane. Oh, Shawnee Ball, shoot. Personalized message. What do you want me to say, Shawnee Ball? Get it a highlight.
Forever loving your content. Kept me sane through lockdown and reignited my once was dying obsession for this game.
I'm glad I could help, Jonimo. And thank you for the 3 months. Congratulations on cooking your bacon and getting to the TTS threshold. It's a big moment out there. I want to get up to 75 minutes so that I can scale this team back. Yeah, you go there. Let's keep it. Alright, we're just gonna kill the rest of this game off. Last 15 minutes pass without incident. Easy. Pro 8, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime. Javon95, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime. Thank you to you both for spending Jeff Bezos' money to be a part of the Hammers. It means a lot to me. What is this personalized message that you speak of? Ladies and gentlemen, here is the redeemed personalized message from Shawnee Bull. Danny Ings is the GOAT. Capital O, capital A, capital T. For some reason. I'm not even denying that, dude. Really, Jonimo, that means a lot. I'm glad I've been able to help so many people through the lockdown. It's been fun. This is a fantastic high-minded debate, chat, that we've had. Does winning a championship, like a world champ, like World Cup, is obviously a World Cup, there's a lot of luck to it. I mean, if Mario Götze just happens to choke a little bit, Messi could very well have a World Cup and the whole narrative's different. Can Messi be the best player of all time without a World Cup? He's got plenty of Champions Leagues, right? He's got plenty of league titles. He's got plenty of trophies in the cabinet, obviously.
My homie Lewandowski is getting the trophy today.
Well, if you think so, Pago, thank you for the 3 months. My homie Lewandowski's getting the trophy today. Lewandowski has a Champions League trophy, right? Right? Yeah. He has to. He's got one. For sure. My God, he doesn't. Yo, he doesn't have one? The last time Bayern won was the year before he moved to Bayern? That makes sense. I just forgot. Madrid with the three, and then there was the 4 and 5, and then Liverpool, obviously, last year. Damn, dude. Oh, I'd be that squeaky bum time for Lewandowski. I knew it was at stake for PSG, you know. I know he lost the final with Dortmund against Bayern, but I was just like, wow. You just assume all the guys at big clubs like that, except for PSG, because they always choke, have one, right? Like, that's what you assume. Like, Kevin De Bruyne doesn't have one because he's in Manchester City. Neymar has one from Barcelona. Good old Barcelona. No, get out of there. Away with you, demon. Run! Vamos a la playa! Why are you shooting? Why are you offside, man? You're the only guy up there. You can figure this out, okay? I believe in you. I'm gonna save one sub just in case there's some late change. All right, sweet. That's a game, ladies and gentlemen. That's a 1-0 win thanks to Brian Galvan. Top of the league. Top of the league. That's what I'm talking about. We lost Dylan Barrero, but that's okay because De Armas is on the way back from injury. It's almost like a theme or something. Christian with a K. Thank you so much for the 2 months. Didn't even need Jeff Bezos money. Neither did Swazi. Both of y'all are in the Hammers and you're in there with a tier one like. In there. Thank you guys for the 2 months. You both are 1 month away from cooking your bacon. You're on like this. You're on the same path. You're on the same journey. Shawnee Ball didn't read. Oh, my dude, it was the wrong guy. Holy Moses, Shawnee. I'm so sorry. Why are there multiple shiny balls? We need to streamline the personalized message process, dude. Aren't you, is it supposed to be a tat? I want you to say that Igor Agafea is the best player of all time. That's the actual shiny ball. Oh, heavens. After a misread, it's time for a personal statement. Igor Akinfeev is the greatest player of all time. Why do you always play with genitals? It's the same we're doing right now.
Premier League winner, Super Cup winner, FIFA Club World Cup winner, World Cup winner, Louisiana League winner. GOAT.
Louisiana League! No! No! It's the Louisiana League! Oh, no. The Louisiana League. He won the Louisiana League, chat. So for those that have no idea what just happened, La Liga, obviously LA space Liga. LA is the abbreviation for the American state of Louisiana. So the TTS just went Louisiana League like nothing happened. Like we wouldn't even notice. Wow, huge game coming up. We're playing second of the league. Messi ain't even win the Louisiana League, chat. How's it going, bro? All caught, I'm excited. We're just processing the fact that apparently Thierry Henry, according to Alvwells, won the Louisiana League, according to the TTS. The Louisiana League. Thank you so much for the 6 months. I mean, he got to silver bacon, chat. It's one thing to get to silver bacon, but to get to silver bacon with the Louisiana League in tow. It's a legendary maneuver by Alvwell. Thank you so much for the 6 months. Oh, dude. Dude. Jose Gomez gets four whenever Excalibur Guerrero likes to lob the keeper. You know what? I don't care. Yeah, absolutely. But Alcott, I'm excited for later, man. I'm looking forward to watch the Champions League. BS being a part of the punditry, I think it's gonna be a load of fun. I think it's gonna be a great. I hope it's a great game, right? I hope it's a great game. Lewandowski looking for his first Champions League, which is a fact that somehow I hadn't put together yet. Bayern hadn't won it in like 8 years. What are you going for? Let me see the lineups before I make a final pick. I got to see the lineups. Jose Sanchez. They're trying to do a takeover. What? But it's dead in the water. Okay. They were signed. I didn't know that we were in the middle of that. I didn't know we were in the middle of that. Can't wait until Real New Orleans gets the Liga. Louisiana Liga and dominates for 80 years. Dude, I'm really excited too. Real New Orleans is already there. You're not paying attention. You've seen Real New Orleans coming up the pipeline.
What's the major you're studying for in Syracuse? A broadcast digital journalism major with a concentration in sports media. Yeah, lineups. No, I know. We'll have the lineups when I go. Do you think Thiago Silva in his final game for PSG wins it for him? Remember when they beat Dortmund? Man, I really want Dortmund to win that. Well, there was like the stretch where Dortmund and Atletico kept popping up in the final. And Atletico was around multiple times. And you're just like, God, you just wish a team like that would win it. Honestly, I'm super happy for Liverpool fans that they were able to win the Champions League last year. But can you imagine if Tottenham had won it? Can you imagine the kind of release that would happen? You obviously never watched the Louisiana League. You wanted it Red Bulls. Thierry Henry. Well, yeah, I mean, why would you want to go to anywhere else? Red Bulls runs the Louisiana League. Who's trying to take over Genetos? Some businessman. I tried to click on his name, but he's not linked in the game, so it's not like a former player or coach or something. Hey, what happened to that personal message professing your love of the Hokies? I'm pretty sure I read it and burned it. Actually, funny story. Yeah, Atletico and Dortmund had two major problems. The real problem for Atletico was Sergio Ramos having the forehead of a Greek god. Like, Atletico was about to win it, and then Arjen Robben with the weakest game-winning shot of all time. I mean, obviously, it was a deserving goal, and it was a great play, and the pace of that bald magician will always amaze me, but that was, he just, like, over the line, and you're just like, dude, you gotta score more emphatically than that. If you, like, it's a freaking winner. You know, I can hit a ball harder than that. I know it's because he like was in the middle of that scramble and trying to roll it by the guy to the opposite side. But I was just like, man, really? That's the goal. You know, you want like a thumper to be. Do I can't offer people trials. Like, what is happening? What is this? Why can't I offer people paper? I want to offer paper trials. Yep, words, love words. Big fan of words. All I want to do is offer him trials, and all of a sudden that option is like not, it's not here. I'm really confused, chat. I don't know. There's no future deal agreed. We're not limited in the number of people we can have on trial. We're just slowly letting all the people that we can have on trial go because we cannot offer them trials. It's a glitch, I think. There's no other way around it. It's pretty straightforward. There is nothing happening in Juan Pablo Ramirez's life that would preclude him. Is it seriously because of the takeover? We're not in the middle of a takeover. It freaking fell apart, even if that was. Dude, that is ridiculous because we're not. I got one of those messages like a month ago that was like takeover talks. The preliminary message is like speculation over a takeover. There's no substance to the rumors, the owner of the club said. And then I just got that message 2 days ago. Club general board status. Thank you. I didn't want to look around for it. I knew it was probably somewhere. Why? We're not. I got the generic message, which the generic message obviously doesn't do it. And now I got a more advanced message about it also falling apart. Good eye, chat. Good eye. Chat. I'm losing all my guys on trial that have been with the club for months because you fools can't figure out. Look, if somebody wants to buy us because we're now a top flight team, I'm all for it, right? You want to come in with your moolah and your status, right? God, I forgot Candelo was injured. We've been doing all this without Yerson Candelo. It's insane. All right, De Armas is the last right winger we have. De Armas is the last airbender, chat. Why did I just drop Kelvon?
Jose Luis Casado.
Present. Okay, cool.
I don't need my phone. Why are you going off? Hey, Siri. Off.
That's what I thought. Try me, dude. I'm right here. I'm waiting. All right, this is going to be a fun game, chap. The emotions are going to be high. If we win it, we're the dead-on favorite to pull away in this phase right here. We are the dead-on favorite. We are playing Junior FC. We have a match in hand. If we beat Junior FC, we are we're well and truly on our way. On the road, Junior FC. On the road, Junior FC. Who you're in for in the playoffs, if anyone? NBA? Basketball? I'm not really, really upsets. I'd love to see a little chaos, a big team lose in the first round, but I think that's what everybody's rooting for all the time. What size shirt are you, large? How's Syracuse? It's nice. It's pretty rust beltish, right? It's pretty rust beltish. You just have a takeover, get sacked. Dude, I literally have an A plus. I never had an A plus with Bate, and I won the Champions League in 9 years with a team from Belarus. I have an A plus right now. I have a straight up A plus. Is Candelo on this thing? At least he's on the freaking report. So's Darmus, who's starting, but who cares? He's fine. Colonel Joe Bacon. Ska, thank you so much. Oh, wow. That was abrupt. Thank you for the prime. For spending Jeff Bezos money like that. I'd like the Raps to sweep the Bucks in the Eastern Conference Finals. I think that'd be very difficult to do. Alfwell, redeem. Oh, what person? Jeez, man. What personal messages? You gotta post. What am I saying? What am I saying? You know? Ladies and gentlemen, we have a personalized message. This one goes out to Alfwell. Thierry Henry will create a Louisiana league just to win it. Nah, he's like not a good coach right now. You notice that? He's a coach now. For those that don't know, long live the Louisiana league. Bless. Big man, what you want? Yeah, he's a bad coach. He'd go back to playing. He'd still be the best player on the teams he's coaching. Have you ever been to Scotland? Twice. I'm from the Shannon clan, man. Get that pride out there. I think we left in the 1600s, though, so it's like way back there. We went to Ireland and then to Canada and then Florida for some reason. You know the coolest thing? Dude, the coolest thing about the streaming, right? And just be like doing this and it taking off and being like a dream, right? And thank you guys for that. Is that when COVID is lifted, right? I'm gonna be able to go wherever I want in the world. And when I go there, whether I go to Scotland and hang out with Jassy, whether I go to Serbia and hang out with the, oh my God. Like befriended this guy in Serbia who wants to give me a tour of like, you know, I'm gonna be able to meet someone and be like, and just hang out, go have a beer, and go to a game, whatever. Like that is just so cool. I have been to Wales as well, yes. All right, we got one more personalized message before we get into the biggest match of the season. This is gonna hurt. I can already tell. This one goes out to Big Man on Campus with a personalized message just for you. My favorite UVA moment that is unique
Oh, no.
And reaches no bounds. Anyone can win a national championship, but to be the first number one seed to lose to a 16 is a symbol of rare greatness to achieve. To know that will also be there is something we can truly be proud of as a UVA fan.
Now, wait, I'm not done.
A national championship is actually, it's not something everybody can achieve. Zeelan, why is that? Because Virginia Tech has never won one at any sport. Ever. Put it in the pipe and smoke it.
Love you, big man. But you set yourself up for that one, didn't you?
You're the only one seed to lose to a 16. I know. I read it. I suffered through the pain. I owned it. Okay. I owned it. But I gotta have my clap back in there.
Do you ever restart matches?
No, I don't. It ruins the immersion for me. It does. It ruins the immersion for me. Gambling, what you got, man?
It's rarer than a national championship win.
Not necessarily. Like for Virginia Tech, they have zero number one seeds ever, right? So they've never had the opportunity to lose to a 16. And you don't have a national championship at every sport. Big man, I love you as a person. My hatred for Virginia Tech is pure and unadulterated. Pure and unadulterated. Score predictions for today's match. You'll see that on All Cut. I'm delaying that as long as possible. What's up? We all love Krause. How you doing? So, Gambling Blues, hit me up after this match because this is a huge match. I want to lock in. I want to make sure we can handle it. I'll make sure we can get the 3 points. Hit me up after this match for your personalized message, all right? It's become the personalized message stream of the day. This is between 1 and 2 in the league here in our first year in the top flight. Edwin! Pass it to Edwin! Oh, Galvan's gonna... Okay, I mean, like, don't shoot, though. Don't shoot. Uh-oh. Mom, I'm scared. Oh. Yeah! Atta boy. Thank you, Dixon. Dixon Renteria, ladies and gentlemen. Well, damn it, my team talk. I got some nerves up. Whip the nerves up a little bit. I'm going to have to compliment them at halftime, so hopefully they do something that makes me want to compliment them at halftime. Yo, a draw is not actually fine. I'd love to pick up 3 points. I know we're on the road against the second-best team in the league, but there are, like, 3 other teams within striking distance of us, so a draw actually allows them to catch up to us. Make a play. Oh, that's a play. That is a ball and a half. Come on. Choke. You choked. Good. How can you breathe with that much blocking your airway?
Miguel, what are you doing?
Miguel! The goal, man! Yeah, it could be worse. I mean, nil-nil half. There's not a lot in this game. I know it could be worse. There's not a lot in this game, but oh, dude. Dude. All right, we need to get team talk. I'm pleased with how things are going. Don't be as nervous. I'm sorry. I raised our expectations a little too quickly. It's my bad. Johnny Cano's having a bad one, and this is not, that is not the guy we want to have a bad game right now. We want Johnny Cano to be electric. 33-year-old talisman, don't you know Johnny Cano? Have that ball, please. What? What? How is that physically possible? Oh, that's a bad, you're not gonna get a better free kick chance than that. Man, score! He like did score. This is too perfect. His header was too perfect. Like hit the corner and just kiss. On the plane of the goal. It did not cross the line. There we go. Uh-oh. Yes, it's a counter. No, it's not. It's a counter. It is. No, it's, oh, no, it's not. It's definitely not. It's not a counter. Oh, thank you. Come on! Virginitos, baby. Virginitos. Give me that goal. We've been the more deserving team in the second half. That's a really hard argument to make, actually, but we did almost... We've been the closest to scoring a goal. Good pass. Daramus. Little creativity like he's capable of. All right. Making a change. Fine. Julian Bray for Miguel Medina. Luis Eduardo Vidal. Luis Eduardo Vidal for Johnny Cano. I can't, dude. I just can't. We gotta undo all this. Luis Eduardo Vidal there. Johnny Cano in the middle. Vidal and De Armas with the big time crossing game to the bit. And the reason I'm doing that is because now I'll have two traditional wingers. I have a traditional winger on each side, which is rare for the way we set up. You know, normally we have like a playmaker or something. What a terrible header by Dixon. Oh no. And Johnny Cano is better in the air than Julian Bray, right? It would be my pleasure to meet you in Scotland and go for a beer, go to football with you, dude. Yeah, it's totally something I'm in for. Absolutely. Virginia doesn't have much to say in American football. There's not an argument. Nuclear memes aside, I would, yeah. Wilker Ferreira, Vandervoort, if he reaches his potential, will be better than Wilker Ferreira's. And Wilker Ferreira's is a deity. So imagine how good Vandervoort's going to be. I'm not going into attacking. We're playing with traditional wingers. We're going to get the ball out to them. We're going to get it into Johnny Cano. He's going to tap a ball home. Okay, that's how this works. That is how this works. At least right now, that's how it works. At some point, we might go to Julian Bray just because he's got a lot of pace and he strikes a good ball. Love for him to just keep the fullbacks in play here. We've got great fullback. Oh, that's nice. Vidal! Oh! Luis Eduardo Vidal. Yes.
Let's go. Oh my God. We did it again. This team is so clutch. So unbelievably clutch. You're a deep lying playmaker. Congratulations. You've won the prize. Etier for Herrera, Mojica back as well. On the road, second best team in the league. They said it couldn't be done. Nobody said that, but we're still doing it. Oh, let's go. Let's go. Okay. Five minutes left. Out. Good. After this match, left five more to try and win the phase. We won one phase the entire time we were in the second division, and now our first season in the top. Oh no, dude, what a save. This guy's offside. The first guy was not. That save was nuts. Juan Lemus off his line. Quick reaction save to save the day. That was the chance. Actually, I think that the first guy might have been off. They didn't get even a half chance for that, and that's like an obvious clear-cut chance. So I think the first guy was offside. Still a nutty save. Get out of here. Well, that was a little nerve-wracking, gentlemen. In the 91st minute, Olafidal. He's got pace. He's got a lot of pace and a lot of path crossing. That's all he has. For him to be the guy that scored is just really random. He just happened to have his finishing boots on today. Oh my goodness, Hyro. The guy that you just can't make that mistake, dude. I'm dropping you, Hyro. For Gonzalo Scafati, and that's how we're going to see this match out the moment that this fizzes a little bit. There we go. Gonzalo, get in there. Get in there, Gonzalo. Did we? Okay, good. We made the sub. It didn't pop up. It's good. Just take your time. Take your time. And why is one of their midfielders marking my striker? They're not able to press at all from that. Oh my goodness. Mojica. Darmus is hurt. Darmus is always hurt though, so this isn't a surprise. This is... Blow the freaking whistle, man! Almost on the 95th. Thank you. God. Let's go. Luis Eduardo Vidal, the 18-year-old loaned in. First goal for the club. The fans are singing his name. Big, big, big stuff. Gambling Blue, what's your message? Do we need to make the personalized message more expensive? Probably. Dude, you're getting this glitch thing. It's being super weird today. You're getting that noise. What is that? But you're not actually seeing the transition. OBS and I need to have a freaking talk, man, because it's just been weird recently. That is what's supposed to happen. You got a baby at sometimes, man. It's just weird. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this one goes out to Gambling Blues with a personalized message. This message also goes out to my mother, because Gambling Blues is just looking out for me. Hey, Mom. Love you. And I miss you. You know, I appreciate the sentiment, Gambling Blues. We actually talk on the phone every day. That's a very kind thing to do to make sure that I said that today. Because I don't think we actually talked on the phone yesterday for the first time in since I got up here. But I made a deal with her. I was like, we're going to talk on the phone every day. So I do try. Okay. I do try to talk on the phone with her every day. That's the effort. Is it better to switch tactics or change positions in a tactic when you want to park the bus?
Changing positions in a tactic. Might be wanting a new contract here, dude. No. Oh my God, Miguel, you're a disease. Even when you're happy, you're unhappy. I make you happy with the amount of playing time you want. Even when you're happy, you're unhappy. We're getting Francisco Arista Sabal joining the club shortly, and he, you know, he's better than you. He does the things that we're looking for out of our forward that you don't. Miguel, and like you're scrappy and you dig in there, but I was really planning on selling you in the next phase. I don't want to have this conversation, but I have to. And I just, you know, what the f-
I just accidentally clicked twice. Let's just take a moment and recuperate. I just accidentally double clicked it. That was the worst time possible to accidentally double click ever. It's okay. We'll be fine. Miguel kind of wants a new contract though, so I don't, I don't really know what we're going to do here. Let's just, all right, Zealand, here's what I want you to do. Zealand, I want you to give him a new contract, because if you don't, he'll burn the house down. But you're gonna, all of a sudden, irreconcilable differences will appear in the next phase. That you will be forced, really against your will, by the forces of nature to sell him anyways. It will be harder to sell him because he just got a new contract, but that's the price to pay for having the stupidest clicking hand.
Oh, God, really? Thank God. Oh, bless the holy spirits of Football Manager for that one. I'm playing a dangerous game here, chap. I'm playing a dangerous game. Shut it off like your transition audio, dude. Oh, Alfwell, don't worry. I saw you. I was going to get you in a second, dude. I did not. Oh, I found your... Okay, you posted your message. I saw that you had the redemption. I was just going to get to it. I am paying attention now. I have the redemption feed up this time. I pulled it up so I wouldn't miss. He wants so much money. He wants a lot of years. I'm playing a dangerous game here, because if I give him this contract and I can't sell him, we have a problem. This would be the LE key. We can't even do that.
Bruh! He sucks! Why is he here? In the core social group? That's not a surprise, but...
Oh my God. He is important right now for this team. He's very important.
Give him that David Luiz money. Won't be a problem.
Buell, thank you so much for the 3 months of the Twitch Prime. Why no 1080p quality? We're in standard definition as long as I'm in Syracuse, unfortunately. That's just what we're able to get to work consistently all the time. I don't want to let him be mad because I want to win now. He is important to me winning now. He is. Buell, congratulations. I cook your freaking bacon, by the way. David Luiz money. That Willian money, you know. Arsenal just vacuum cleaning up all these players. Thush, thank you for the prime. Why do we use per annum instead of per week? It's just what we do in the United States. It's like standard operating procedure in the United States. In the US version of the game, it comes in and it's per year. Any advice on how to get my star winger out of his massive slump for the last six games? Just tell him you have faith in him. Like in a personal conversation, say, hey, you know, I got faith in you, pick your head up, that sort of thing. But I offer him this contract and I'm not able to sell him. I'm really screwed, but I feel like I have to now that I accidentally clicked because we needed to make sure that he didn't get mad this year because he is like him and Julian Bray are the strikers. Johnny Cano plays there too, but him and Julian Bray are the strikers. He's got a job to do. He has a job to do. Here, I think a win tonight. I mean, I picked PSG going through. We had this conversation obviously right off the top of the stream, but I picked PSG going through and then like from the restart, but the way Bayern's been playing, man. Like if I was betting my mortgage, I'd bet it on Bayern, but I'm sticking with PSG because from the beginning, I thought they were right. Fellow American Football Manager player, how'd you get into the game? My friend introduced, he just said, hey, check this game out. I mean, I don't know how he found it. I mean, it's not advertised over here at all. That hurt. That ruined my long-term plan with what to do with Miguel Medina, which was to sell him in the next phase. We can still sell him in the next phase. Just terrible, terrible form with the clicking finger. Clicking hand. Picking PSG over Bayern here to collect my salt. I picked him from the onset. What do? Go against the team you pick from the onset now? They got here. What did you actually click on? So I clicked rapid fire and basically what I said was, hey, are you interested in like, so I started the conversation, right? Which is what I was attempting to click on, which is where you say, hey, I heard you were thinking about maybe getting a new contract. And then he says something like, yeah, boss, I just think, you know, the way I've been playing recently that I deserve a new contract. I'd love, you know, there's not a long run on my current contract and I'd love to stay here long term. And the top option, which happens to be on the same line as the thing I clicked previously is, you know what? That makes sense. We'll offer you a new contract in the near future. And of course, if you don't offer him a new contract in a couple of days, he'll get super mad. Complete evisceration of all trust. And then, you know, it's over. Darmus is just like, oh my God. I'm out of right wings, dude.
Let's go, Bayern.
Barrero and Candelo are hurt. Darmus is unable due to fitness reasons to be able to play in this game. Matt, we know where Max Noob lies. Thank you for the five.
Bacon!
We know where Max Noob plays lies. The five gifted subs. Thank you so much for those. And thank you kicking off a hype train, dude. That's a lot of
bacon.
You have a successful start of YouTube live stuff. First, in up, save now with this Medina. Stay tuned for the next one. Yeah, I know. Yeah, the first time I deleted the save file and now I make that massive mistake.
It's okay.
Who are your favorite American teams? I don't have a favorite basketball team. But my NFL, NHL, and baseball teams are all Tampa. Yeah, I'm from Tampa. That's my city.
That's my city. Those are my teams.
Fine, I'll play Miguel, and if he scores, all of a sudden we look like a genius, right? If he scores, we look smart. If he doesn't, we don't. Oh, we've offered him the contract. Here he is. Here's Miguel. Here's Johnny. Man, I had three guys that can play right wing, and none of them can play today. It's just remarkable. Jose, you're in.
Daramas is coming off the bench just because. Mahika's got to back down. He's got to be down here, and I'll put him on attack so he gets further forward when he's got the ball, but he's got to be farther down. He's not comfortable being that far up the field. He doesn't know what to do. He's going to get lost. Even if I give him a map, he won't know where to go. That's just how we got to set ourselves up. We can bring Daramas on to get a little farther forward if we need to, right? If we need to lurch forward, then we'll do that, but he can't play the full game. Killa Orange, huge fan of the YouTube content. Helped me so much. Finally able to catch a stream. Whereabouts are you in this project? I'm at Generals in Colombia. I'm 8 from Argentina, Fran Antonini, and we're in season 4. We just got promoted last year, and we're actually doing really well in the top flight. I see a lot of your YouTube videos on YouTube. Great advice. One question. In what role would you use Frankie de Jong? I'm using him right now as a roaming playmaker. I feel like a playmaker of some kind. I don't know about roaming. Official Palmer, having great coaches is only a small part of the battle of developing players. They still need to have the potential to grow, and it's a lot, the facilities, right, and how much potential the player has and how willing they are to reach that potential is also important. So you have to keep that in your mind, Palmer, that it's not just your coaches. Your coaches, if you have great coaches, they're doing everything they can, so it's other stuff. Rays have fans? They do. They just don't go to the games. I don't go to the games. Rays have fans. Yes. Alvo, can you repost your personalized message, please, so we can get to it? Love you, Dad. Love you too, Yessie. Son, I'm very proud of you. Do you guys like this video? We came out with this video, like a newer style of video, right? It's good. I liked it a lot. That was, it came out at the same time that Lad Bible posted, they re-edited our video. They sent me an email. They're like, yo, can we re-edit this video and post it? And I was like, yeah, it sounds good. And so I came out with another video that was kind of like the one that they re-edited and posted at the same time. If you enjoy that type of stuff, that's definitely stuff that I'm always going to be making the Football Manager tutorials and stuff like that. But that's definitely the type of stuff we're looking to expand into. That's part of like working with Alcott today. We're going to be on with Alcott, watch the Champions League, right? Your Pulisic anthem gave me goosebumps. I mean, I'm trying to a couple of record labels called me after that video came out, and they were like, hey, you know, we're interested. And I was like, well, I mean, sorry, boss. Yeah, I'm already busy. And they're like, well, please. I had to turn them down. They were begging. You have to serenade someone like Christian Pulisic, you know? They deserve serenading. Anything else on FM21? No, not yet. I suspect we won't start hearing stuff until October. And that's when they'll start a promotional train of telling us about new features. I don't think we'll hear anything else about it until then. The only reason we heard about it before was because they had to confirm with us that the game was coming out, right? Did you get any salty? I mean, always, yeah. There's always going to be the one guy who's like a Brighton fan or something, and I say Brighton just doesn't feel like a Premier League team. And he's like, oh, this lad, he's got no idea what he's talking about. You know? He's right. I don't. That's like the point of the video, though. I'm trying to learn. Get my real football knowledge up there. I was talking to HITC7s the other day. I might try and do a video with him. He's a fan of the channel, and I'm obviously a huge fan of his. He's really smart about translating that knowledge out. Right. Yeah, I found a Sporkle quiz. It'd be cool to see you do it before the match. About this year's Champions League. What's the Sporkle quiz? All right, there's the message. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this one goes out to Alvwell, a personalized message straight from the desk. The 1996 Nebraska Cornhuskers are the best college football team of all time. Scoring more than 50 points against every team they played, including the championship game against the Florida Gators. This far surpassed anything any football team in the state of Virginia has ever done. Isn't HITC7's good, though? Dude, I love his videos.
And he was like, oh yeah, dude, love the channel. And I was like, oh, pff, that's weird.
I expect nothing but a win from this match. Gentlemen, y'all good. You must act like it.
All right, we're playing a bit of a weird formation today, a little off kilter. Right wing a little further back so Anderson Mojica feels comfortable in his positioning. Doesn't get absolutely filleted. We're at home against Once Caldas. We should be good. Let's go. You recommend for small streamers, I'm risking everything to make it work. Don't do that.
Big dubs.
Big dubs, buddies, mom. Thank you for the Twitch Prime for the 4 months. Thank you for the... Yeah, that dude, Jeff Bezos is feeling it today. So many Twitch Primes. If you hit that subscribe button, right? You hit that subscribe button. Let me get up here for this. You hit that subscribe button and you're like, yo. Yo. I have a free sub. Spend it somewhere, because it's five. If you don't, it's $5 that Bezos gets to keep. Or you spend it here if you want to be part of the Hammers. You can spend it like, I don't care. Who's your favorite? Spend it there. Spend it somewhere. You should have a free sub thanks to that Amazon thing. And if you don't spend it, that's just literally $5 that Bezos gets to keep. It's straightforward. Very straightforward. Ah, FM and Gunshala. ¿Cómo estás? Do YouTube videos help Big Ivan get Tencent? Don't risk everything to make it work. But on the flip side of that, if you want streaming to be a career, sorry, Tencent just said, what do you recommend for small streamers? I'm risking everything to make it work. There's a balance, right? You have kids, you have a significant other, you have anybody relying on you to provide for them. If you do, don't quit stuff and go try and be a streamer, because this is one of the hardest jobs to make it in. It's because everybody wants to do it, right? Just like huge streaming business conversation we're about to have. I promise I'm going to keep it short if you don't find it interesting. But here, good evening, Jericho. Hope you're doing well. But I'm not going to go the other way and say, well, you know, don't go all in. Don't. Just have fun with it, and if it happens, it happens. That's not true either. Ask every single person that has ever turned like streaming and YouTube into a career, whether they just kind of like, well, you know, let's just, you know, there's a certain point where you go, I want to do this. I'm going to approach it like something I want to be my career, right? I absolutely love doing this. And so approach it like that, but don't. You don't know how long it's going to take, right? But there's a Chinese proverb, right? Great wealth takes luck. Small wealth takes perseverance. I think that's really true. I think if you want to be ninja, right? Obviously, he's freaking nasty at first-person. If you want to be Tim the Tap Man, who's not good at first-person shooters, he's better than me, but point stands. A little luck has to go into being that famous, but like perseverance and self-reflection can get you the small. Don't Chinese proverb. I will Chinese proverb you into the sun, sir. But the perseverance and self-evaluation, eventually you'll be able to get yourself to a point that you never imagined you'd be able to get to, and that small wealth point, right? And you approach it like a business, but don't go all in, because you don't know when that's going to happen, right? It could happen in 6 months. It could happen in 3 years. It took me 2 years to do anything. And all I was doing in those 2 years was trying and failing to do something. And eventually I found something that people were like, dude, love this. Want to watch this. And I was like, sick. Here you go. You know? Pro tip of yourself. Yeah, that's like, I don't get asked this a lot, which is why I'm so enthusiastic when somebody asks, because like, ask. It's what I did. I asked. I went to people that I liked watching and I'm like, yo, you know, like, what do I do? Right?
But risking it all, right? If I'd risked it all 2 years ago, I never would have been able to sustain myself long enough to get to the point where I actually made it. Keep the job. And just work really freaking hard, right? Before I hired Reese to do the editing, right? I was putting in like 10, 12 hours a day to get 3 videos out a week and stream like every day. Don't stream every day. That was the thing I learned. You don't have to stream every day. Not only is it super draining, right? I don't have the time anymore because we're doing so many other things. I'm obviously also in school. Should I have all my youth players in the main squad and just make them available for the youth teams? Not all of them, just the best ones. The real stars. But if you ever have any streaming questions, I've been asked less than 10 streaming questions by other people in my life. I'm very enthusiastic about answering them, like, because I feel like nobody asks. And I feel like one of the things that really just helped me to be able to do this and be able to put myself in a position where I could hopefully make you guys' days better, right? It's because I asked. Does it always feel like fun? Yes. That's a misconception sometimes I think people have is that, I mean, well, some streamers have that, but I'm not the dude that's playing Apex 20 hours a day, right? But they're just like, God, I'm only playing this for the money, like boom, 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 you know? And that, I don't know if I would want that life. I would love to be that good at a video game, right? I don't know if I want that life. But that's not what I'm doing, right? I stream like 16 to 20 hours in a whole week. Every second I'm on, I'm loving it. I love playing Football Manager. I'm sad that I can't play Genetos unless I'm streaming. I'd love to be able to play it in another, like, but you know, the normal situations I played it in. Hey, Alaris Bacon, thank you so much for gifting the sub to Pavel QC. Welcome to the Hammers. What's a good starting camera for streaming? A C920. It's like, oh, well, your phone. I streamed off my phone for a year. There's a little app you can get on your phone. I'm only saying this because we just got a penalty, so hopefully we'll be able to relax and have this conversation while we're picking up 3 points here. But welcome, Pavel and DK Vendi. Don't think I didn't see you. Bacon! With that Twitch Prime, dude. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Any advice for at least half my team always having 6.5 below away from home? Encourage them in the team talk more. Can I text you on Twitter? Yeah. Sometimes listening in English is difficult. Tenzin, completely understand your English is a lot better than my Portuguese. Message me on Twitter. Yes. Any tips for international management? Make sure that you, if you're looking at your national pool, make sure you add new players to your national pool. You have to add players to your national pool. Remember that. How much did your graphics cost you? The ones that I have now, like $600 probably. But this is like the fifth edition of, you know, I think one of the keys is when you start making money, make sure you spend it on making the stream better, right? You've helped massively. Oh, Fendi, dude, I'm glad I could help. When doing a player search, can I filter by height? It should be in general, right? How long you been streaming? Since March 2018. I mean, I have a lot of graphics. We've got all those scenes. I can't go to them today. All our special scenes because we've got the old choppy audio issue, but yeah, it's a shame. The choppy audio today is a big concern for me because I did restart my computer right before the stream. Shoot. Oh, dude! Didn't have Johnny Cano to take the penalty. He's great. Probably said this, but prediction, PSG. Bayern's been playing brilliantly. I just think this is PSG's Champions League to win. I just think it's PSG's Champions League to win. Ever thought about doing a save with all nations at youth rating 200? I mean, I don't know what would happen. Everybody would be even, right? It would just come down to who has the better facilities, but who has the better facilities already? All the best countries in the world. So, like, best facilities and coaching. Maybe like China, where the facilities are great, but the youth rating is garbage. Like, maybe that's the sort of country that would be great. Watching Bruins Lightning tonight? Yeah. Beer in hand, Bruins Lightning on the telly. The telly. Golvan. Charlotte, I love it. I love it. I don't know how nobody's come up with Golvan yet. Brian Golvan. Are you stopping the stream before the game, or are you doing like a watch party? No, we were raiding James Alcott, and then I'm on James Alcott's stream with like one or two other people, and we're going to be watching and providing punditry live during the game. I think it's going to be amazing. He reached out to me and was like, you want to do this? I was like, absolutely. You know, I'm just a fruity guy. I have not ever played Rocket League. No, I don't. It's, you know, Oh, is Dan coming in? Is Dan coming in? We got to brace ourselves, dude. Dan's big time now. Beer of choice? Probably a Yingling or a Heineken. You know, but I'm not like a super beer person in terms of like I know all the... God, he's offside. I don't know the specifics, you know. Ladies and gentlemen! Defend the reign. Get your emotes. Hold them at the gates. Viking Dan is here. The Vikings are pillaging the monastery. Save all the gold. Dan, thank you so much for coming over. Say hi to Dr. Limpo for me, man. That was, like, super cool. Dan, thank you for the 5 months as well. Viking Dan, the sub. Well, he was pretty busy.
Pogden,
Blam, thank you so much. The 21 months on a streak, dude. 21. We know emotes are flying all over the place, chat, but 21 months is insane. Blam, one of the OG hammers out here with 21 months. Absolute madness. All your priests belong to us. Proper defense of the walls, hammers. I saw the emotes. We brought the heat. We put up the, you know, we put up the shields. We held them at the gates. Very well done. And if you're with Viking Dan's stream, my name is Sealand. We just conceded a goal that I am very unhappy we conceded because I thought we had a good half. We are currently top of the phase in the top flight of Colombia, and our first season in the top flight of Colombia after 3 seasons in the second flight. We battled to promotion. We are in an absolute dogfight. Passionate. We owe them or something. I gotta hit them with I believe in you. We're nervous. I need to break out everything I can to try and overcome this because we're not good right now. We are not okay. Everybody to South Africa, I have not actually. Would you say that they stormed the airports? How to get the match stats on the screen there during the match? I know they're behind my head. I keep it that way so that I can lie to you about how many chances have been created. But you go up here, and then there's match stats, and then you underneath the match stats, right, you can click customize, and then you can add. There's like so many options, right, that you can add for your match stats. I should put that in a video, shouldn't I? Should absolutely put. There's some things that I just do reflexively that you've known for a while. Oh, get in. All we needed was a touch there. All we needed was, long throws right away. Get the mindset settled. That was just not even close. Why is this a highlight? Because of something we did later in the play? It is us, after all. It is. Ha ha! Please. All right. I don't know about this. Edwin Herrera's already gone flying forward. Why are Umanya and Casado in the same spot? One's it? Oh my goodness, that was... No, Blitz, you're good. Don't worry. We have a no politics rule. That's the only reason I didn't go in and start laughing. Can the development be bad if you have a heavy load of work in practice from the last question? Yes. Yeah. I believe you can overwork your players. This is not something I've tested. That's why I say I believe. I do believe you can overwork your players, and then they get jaded as you get later into the season. Dude. Thank you. Huge. What up, guys? How things going today? They're going. You play key? I play extended. Bacon! Oh, thank you so much for the two. Hi, see, my midfield's having a wonderful day. All right, first order of business. Daramas is in. Gotta make this change early because Mojica's just having a mare. Johnny Cano is in for Vidal. We do not have time to mess around. We are currently tied. We'll keep that for now, but I've certainly applied too much pressure on my team talks, and we need to scale that back for the future. Yes, I know this. Right now, we need to find a way to win. Find a way to get another goal here. That, you know, when did that work? When was the last time just turning around and soinking it worked? And there's a dude right behind you. Can I overclock them? No. For a little bit, but not a lot. Not a lot of bit. I've just started an Arsenal save. Any advice on making them a European giant? Get rid of the old bad players. Seriously, dump those contracts and spend that money intelligently on young players and you're set. Oh, I like this buildup. Somebody just needs to beat somebody. Oh my goodness. Oh my. What a goal, baby! The Manchester City of this country, okay? Straight out of the back, one touch. Collects the ball. Good buildup. Brian Galvan with... Oh, what a peach. What an absolute peach of a ball. From playmaking extraordinaire Brian Galvan. I mean, that is just on a plate. It's on a plate. What a ball. Oh, good touch. Oh, good ball. He's got Darmus. Can return the favor with a good service. Oh, Cano. He's so good in the air. That honestly looks exactly like a De Bruyne pass, right? That leading cross, it just drops in and he just has to score it. If you're stream watching the final, I'm going to be on a panel on James Alcott's stream. We're going to raid over there right before the game starts. And that's where we're going to watch the final. I won the Champions League and my oldest player was 24. So no, you don't. Man, that was a pretty good free kick. So no, you don't need a Silver Fox. It makes it easier. Palmer, it makes it easier if you have somebody like that. Decanio, thank you for the 2 months. I don't know if I actually said it out loud. I think I just hit the bacon. Yeah. But you're 1 month away from cooking that bacon. And Vikram, thank you for the raid as well. The love. So Dan, if you're still here, what is it like being raided by Dr. Lupo, who is allegedly my older brother? That's an internet conspiracy. That nice. Good little comfort goal, scramble play. Dixon Renteria's got his first. I don't know why. Since I started streaming, people have thought that I was like, oh, are you related to Dr. Lupo? I'm like, no, I don't think so. That'd be a surprise to me as much as it would be to you. Colombia can play in the Champions League? No. I won it with Bate Borisov. That was our first stream. Honestly, why do I love Kevin De Bruyne? Because he plays balls like that. That's why we love Brian Galvan, because he plays balls like that for the second goal. It's amazing. Incredible. Anybody wheezing? Oh, no. Before he tweaks anything else, get him off the field. He's going to score before I take him off. How do you set up corner kicks? I got a video just for that, I promise. I wouldn't lead you astray, but I've got a whole video on the way that I do it and the way that opens up opportunities to score off corners. The preset is terrible, though. You should change it if you haven't. The preset is really bad, gives you very little chance to score. What creativity there from Muscheta. He's like, well, What they'll least expect. Hear me out. Okay. What they will least expect is for me to just kick it out. Nobody will see that coming. And he's right. It's a true statement. He's absolutely right. Rocker, thank you so much. Bacon, thank you for the tier one. Welcome to the Hammers. Make sure you get in the subscriber section of the Discord so that you be involved in videos. You get stream recaps. You get all this cool stuff in that subscriber section. Highly recommend. If you're part of the Hammers, you got to be in there. Subscriber section of the Discord. So I can get in touch with the Hammers staff. And then Ed Drato. Ed Drato, thank you so much for the tier one. Bacon! And the same applies to you. Make sure you get the subscriber section and thank you and enjoy the bacon. Enjoy how the emotes and all that fun stuff. I played some Viking dance. It was funny. I didn't actually realize it was him. My follower alert was just constantly pinging off, so I missed the raid. People were saying Lupo raid, and I thought, surely not Dr. Lupo. Then my viewers jumped to 17K, and I realized they were right. So I played some ads, and now I can afford my rent, dude. Yeah, everybody can join the Discord. There's a subscriber section of it. It's got some extra things for subscribers. What a goal! Sochi on the Scanna, it's 4-1. We've turned our team into a machine, chat. We are machinistic. We only won one phase out of six chances when we were in the second division. We got promoted. And now in our first season of the top flight, we are locking in with four matches to go on a phase win. Renteria just got a red. God, in the 93rd minute, missed the next match because of that, you bumbling fool. You cannot make any more substitutions. Hey, Hyro, you ever played center back before? He's kind of tall. Like, he could totally do it. He just doesn't have the familiarity, you know? You play a whole match in full? No, Lord. No, I'm on extended highlights. Is my that's my, like, right where I'm comfortable is extended highlights. When's the next World Continental Cup going to be on? It's going to be the Gold Cup in one day. And I think it's not next week, but the week after that we're going to do it. But it'll be the Gold Cup in one day. And then the World Cup after that, we'll probably do it the following week since you get all excited for the World Cup once you finish that. Icelandic leagues are weird in FM, but they're fun. So it's just like this, just like comprehensive highlights. Seems like a lot. No, it's extended. I mean, the game match just ended. But yeah, we're on extended highlights. I always like playing extended because you get to see some of the plays that aren't, like, key. It's normally a goal, but in extended, you get to see some of the plays that aren't goals. It helps you make more educated decisions based off what's happening. What attributes should I look for in a great regen? I mean, it depends on what, you know, what position they play and how they're going to play it. But typically a great regen will be pretty balanced. The guys that are going to go on to become the best players in the world are not going to have, you know, they're not going to have nine vision, right? Like, even if they're a keeper, they're not going to have nine vision. If there's a huge, there's types of players that they tend to be just under the top cut of the best regens, right? They're the types of players, I have some on my Bate team that play that as a personal save now, where they'll have like 17 dribbling, first touch, and finishing as a striker, but they'll have like 10 passing. The best play, those guys can be really good and worth a lot of money, and you can buy them and they can help you win even Champions Leagues. But they're not going to be, you know, if you're looking for the next Messi, there usually be about 10 or 12 of these guys in the world at a time. They're going to be really balanced, right? They're not going to have those huge holes in their team. Okay, that injury is going to get over it. Sergio Mosqueda had a goal and an assist. My center back had a goal and an assist. Whew. What do you do when you get 19 points out of 7 matches, then 1 out of 4? Nothing, probably. Unless you were getting outplayed, but I'm assuming you weren't. I'm assuming you were just unlucky, so keep encouraging the team. I mean, actually, since you just had all those wins, to avoid complacency, yell at the team a little bit. But after you've yelled at them a little bit, you keep dropping points, start encouraging them. So sorry for the delay. Keep it up, Golden Content. Lots of fun to watch. Least I can do is sub for your profile. Yo, thank you. No offense to Dan, you're a great streamer, but you just wouldn't expect that. I have no idea. Oh, the Lupo thing. Yeah, Dan was streaming Fall Guys. He was streaming Fall Guys, and so was Lupo. So Lupo just scrolled down the people streaming Fall Guys and rated Dan. First time here. Love the YouTube videos. Dirtimo, welcome. That's a huge step to go from watching the YouTube videos to, like, you want to come hang out here too. Lupo's a huge FM fan. That's what I heard. Finally getting to catch you here. Heavy punch. Well, welcome. We're going to be kicking it for the Champions League in like an hour. An hour and 10 minutes, basically, we're going to go over. Hopefully, we can have the phase all locked up by then, you know? So by the time we get to the Tuesday stream, it'll be all buttoned up, you know? Tuesday, 3:30, baby. Write it down. Put it in your... Oh, here's what I want you to do right now, ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, if you weren't here before, somebody find my phone. I threw it. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to grab your phone. If you're watching on your phone, I want you to grab a piece of paper. I want you to go into your calendar, right? I want you to go into your calendar. I want you to go to Tuesday at 3:30. I want you to click add, right? And then I want you to type in Zealand stream, right? And we're going to put it, make sure you put it on, you know, whatever time it is. I'm on the wrong scrolly thing. Three. That's not three. Oh, heaven help us all. That's 3:30. That's 8:30 London time, PM. And you click add, you know? You put it in there. Tuesday, 3:30. You do the same thing for Thursday at 3:30. And then on Saturday and Sunday at 11 a.m., you do the same thing and you hit add and it's in there. And it's right there. It's there. That's how you do it. That's how you do it, chat. Fenrix with the 4 months, bro. What's up? Nice Icelandic flag, Fenrix says. Oh, well, thank you. I appreciate it. Hi, mom. Hi, how you doing? Love your YouTube content, Big Fish Cow. Fenrix, you're 2 months away, by the way, from Silver Bacon. I just wanted to keep you updated on your fantastic progress. Hey, Medina's happy with his new contract. So Big Fish Kyle, this is the first stream I've been able to catch, but you've helped me so much in my first ever FM save last month. Managed to keep Norwich in the Prem and now I'm addicted. Dude, welcome. Manage the addiction, but I'm glad I could help. Because it is an all-consuming addiction. And turn your notifications on. Right. Already done. So I love it. Much love from Iceland. Much love back. I freaking love your country, man. I've been having a conversation. I don't know if this person's in the chat. If they are, maybe they can give me approval to, like, show you guys this conversation. I was having it on Twitter messages. And I was talking to this dude. And he's from Iceland. His name's Brynjar. And we had a long conversation about why he likes Florida and I like Iceland. And I'm sorry, I'm zoomed in because I have it pulled up right now. And I'm not cool enough to have multiple monitors. My desk isn't big enough. That's what she said. And, that's why we're just looking at my face. And he was talking about, like, this is what Brynjar said. If I want a good burger, the only thing you can think of is KFC in some few Icelandic brands. They're all way too expensive. And I'm over here like, your culture is cool to me because it's the opposite of America. We have everything, all this stuff and all types of, we have everything and everyone and all types of stuff and all this busyness, loud, busy, cutthroat kind of stuff. And then there's Iceland where it's just none of that happening. And he's over here like, bro, I just want a hamburger. You know what I'm saying? Wait, hold on. I accidentally left it up. Oops. It's like, dude, honestly true. Sometimes you're just like, man, I want a hamburger. No love for Ecuador? I always got love for Ecuador. They're right on the equator and they know it. They're proud. Try some fermented shark. I had whale. I was there. Sorry to anybody that offends. I just love trying abstract foods. I'm like a wannabe Anthony Bourdain when I'm traveling. Like, rest in peace, by the way. Love that dude. I had whale. I had that like mashed white fish where they like didn't take the skeleton out of the fish. That was nuts. But I didn't. I didn't have the fermented shark. I've had shark. I had never had the fermented shark. Do you ever think about a radio career? Yeah. I've been told I had the face for radio my whole life. But I enjoyed the TV broadcasting so much. I've done a lot of radio broadcasting. I enjoyed the TV broadcasting so much. There's something in the adrenaline when those lights come on and there's the producer in your ear and he's like, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you're on. And you're just like, welcome to wherever the hell we are for this swimming meet that nobody's watching, and here's my name. Hopefully that's not what I sound like, but no, real talk. It's great. There's just that extra little bit for me. And I think TV is easier because you're freed up a little bit when you're on radio. I think radio is more difficult to do, especially at lower levels, because you have to describe everything, right? You have to paint the picture and then color it in. On TV, the picture's already there. You just have to color it in, right? And so you there's more freedom to talk about the storylines and less that needs to be said in terms of describing the game. I enjoy that. When's the game start? In about an hour 15 is when the game kicks off. We'll parade over to Alcott like 10 minutes before. The surname thing in Iceland is cool. Yeah, as far as I know, Iceland is... Oh, Raul! Or sorry. Bacon. That's not right. It's Raul! Did I get all the U's in there? I feel like I added one extra one. That was a shame. Thank you for continuing your gifted sub from Sloth. Thank you for wanting to be part of the Hammers. Those emotes look frosty in the chat. They look frosty. Dream broadcasting job. Lead broadcaster for NBC so that I get to do the Olympics and some World Cup, hopefully. You ever consider a save in India? Dude, that'd be hard. It'd be so hard. As far as I'm aware, Iceland's the only culture left that's the last name of Icelandic people, as it was explained to me, and this dude might have been messing with me, but when I was there, I've been to Iceland 3 times, and I've done like the real touristy stuff, and I've gotten way off the beaten path, and I sometimes like Icelandic people, then you're like Icelandic or you're not, right? So you walk into these rural rural grocery stores or something. Like, we were in the middle, you know, we were kind of into the middle of Iceland, which is in the middle of Australia, like there's nobody there. And we're keeping, long story short, we're on this horse farm, like 2,000 acre horse farm. It's not ours, but it's like a family friend, great family friend to have. And we're staying at this horse farm in this little cabin. And so we're in the middle of nowhere. We go to a grocery store, and I swear, you walk in and I look like a very normal dude. In Iceland, I don't. I look super foreign. And so you walk in and I just like bumble in my coat. And everybody at the grocery store is just like, and you're just like, oh, hey. Just like, hello. Well, it's one of those things, you know, when you walk in and you're just like, everybody just stares at you and you're like, hello. Hi. Shockingly ethnic in Iceland. I don't know if I go that far, but definitely. Do you watch Champions League in America? It's free on YouTube. Champions League's free on YouTube, call me Coop. UCL final prep is not for the save, but in real life one. Yeah, I knew we'd be talking about it all day. It's for the in real life Champions League. No, we're not in the South American Champions League yet. The way we're playing, we might just be. But it's the reason I said prep is because I'm a pundit for this. Well, I'm going to be on James Alcott's stream, and we're going to be watching the Champions League. I'm going to be part of that, the panel watching the Champions League on with James Alcott. And so it's gonna be a lot of fun. I've heard they're super. Oh, they're really nice. Yeah, they're really nice. But when everybody around you all the time looks the same and you see somebody different, that's what you do. Who else on the panel? No idea. I wasn't paying attention. I'm sorry. Oh no. Your mistake was not having a cod in both hands. Can my Icelandic people in chat confirm or deny this? Because like that definitely happened to me. You ever been fired on FM? Absolutely, yes. If you haven't been fired on FM, you're either cheating, you're doing things to enhance the playing experience for your own enjoyment that would prevent you from getting fired, or you are you have played long enough. Because sometimes it will just go against you. There will be very little you can do, whether you believe that or not. The RNG will just take you to the apps. It will take you to the cleaners. The cleaners. Favorite sport I've ever broadcasted. I got to do a UVA, University of Virginia men's basketball game. We were the number 5 team in the country, and it was a dream come true, really, at that point. We got to meet up when you come back to Iceland. Hafórn, absolutely. There's a solid Icelandic contingent of hammers out there, and I would love, and assuming since 3/4 of the population's in Reykjavik, I was assuming I'd just roll up to Reykjavik and we could all go out and have a beer. It'd be really cool. Absolutely. Zealand Con Iceland. We'll make sure. Has anyone got the new transfer update until now? What do you mean? There was a new transfer update. Came out in March, though. See, I would care, but I don't. Because this is like, if any player on my team was going to get a lower back stress fracture, he's the guy I would hope got the lower back stress fracture. Sorry to say, but it's true. 100% true. Dude, I'm in the north. You're in the northwest. Man. That's a solid drive. It's a beautiful drive. It's a solid drive to get down to Reykjavik from there. Just want some potatoes, people. Completely understand. What I said about Iceland was that when that staring into the camera thing was like, when I walked into the grocery store, I swear the entire grocery store turned around and was like, foreigner identified. And then it like, look, you got to understand, I come from Florida, okay? Florida. If I'm out to dinner and somebody walks into the restaurant with a walrus thrown over their shoulder, I won't bat an eye. I'll just be like, oh, okay. All right. I've seen worse. Anything can walk through that door in Florida. Jack Black riding a donkey. And I'd be like, oh, yeah, it's pretty on brand, actually. Okay. Go back to my chips and salsa. They're fake players, so it's actually not statistic to rationalize their injuries. Did you see that dude? I went at it. I don't get in Twitter fights ever. This is like my first ever Twitter fight. I got in like 2 days ago. This dude essentially did what I just did with Karabali, where I was like, oh, he got a lower back stress fracture, but you know, it's not a problem because if I had to pick anybody on our team to get a lower back stress fracture, I'd pick him. He did that in real life to a 19-year-old kid. That was like his hot take. And I was like, bro, that is not okay. Walrus of, I mean, he's like, Betty, and I wouldn't even watch that news broadcast. Did you basically beef? It was like a regional ESPN account, but yes, I was beefing with a regional ESPN account. That was the thing. I mean, that's a terrible take. It was like a very small regional ESPN account that I was beefing with. But yes, I was beefing with a small regional ESPN account. They were the people with the take. The objectively terrible take of like, well, he got hurt, he tore his ACL, but like, you know, and the trade-off, like, we ended up signing this other guy today, so if I told you at the beginning of the day, you would totally take that, and you're just like, shut up. That's a horrible thing to say. So let me help you. Shut up. Shut up. Let me help you. I will help you be quiet. Yeah, Dietti. It was something, yeah. That was something weird. You know, some people really, they forget that athletes are real people. This is why I'm always so impressed by Neymar. Because I cannot imagine the pressure, the temptation. Right? The morphing of your brain that happens when from the time you are 6 years old, a large portion of the Brazilian footballing world and then the Brazilian populace as you get older is like, second coming. You are the second coming. And he didn't mess it up. How? I would have messed it up 20 times. Yo, yeah, I saw Kyle. They asked me first. They were nice about it. They re-edited the video, so I had to actually send them like an audio-free version so they could re-edit it. But that was really nice support Bible that wanted to use it. That was a lot of fun. From my perspective, the staring doesn't really happen there. Fair enough. This is like rural Iceland just rolled in. Iceland is, the people are incredibly nice and it is absolutely gorgeous. And the culture is fascinating to me because I come from a culture in Florida where Jack Black riding a donkey doesn't get a second glance. Like you're going along with your day and the dude's sitting on the side of the road screaming about the end of the world, you know, because the Pastafarians are showing up. Like, you just, oh, whatever. But Iceland also, it's like you're Icelandic or you're not. Because it's a very, from the people I talked to there, this is not just me like, well, I was here and I'm making this judgment without talking to anyone. It's very protective of its culture, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, Halfhorn, because it is a culture that numerically is very small. And so they don't want to lose it. Right? And so they defend it. And part of that defending it is like, you let in outsiders to a certain point, and then you're like, oh, okay, buddy, you're getting a little high for your, you know, Alfwell, holy bacon! Holy bacon! With a gifted sub 16 in your career, Tie Rocker, welcome to the Hammers. Fluke the UCL title with my finish side many years ahead of schedule in the middle of a generational change. Should I change my long-term plans or accept it was unrepeatable and continue my facility? Continue what you were doing. I mean, that's probably where you wanted to head. Neymar messed it up by moving to PSG? I don't think he did. Back to that Neymar point, I'm just like, look, I would have messed it up 10 times over. If I had to live Neymar's life, I would have done something stupid. I would have. Like growing up now, if you gave me all of that now at 24, I'd be fine. 17, hell no. And he had it all. Could have done whatever he wanted and he kept his head down and he kept working and he kept getting better and became one of the best players in the world. I mean, that is like, I give him an amazing amount of credit even though I don't like the guy. I give him an amazing amount of credit for that. You're right with the culture, but hey, I gotta go. You have a great day today. Halfhorn, thank you. You have a great day too. Thank you for talking to me about Iceland for a little bit, because I think not a lot of people have the opportunity to go to Iceland, but it's on more of the world stage, especially the footballing world stage, because of the World Cup and the Euros and all that stuff. So it's fun to be able to enlighten. I love traveling, and I love the, because traveling allows you to enlighten and learn about all this different stuff. How's Koeman going to do at Barcelona? I think he's going to fail, but I think it's because the players aren't that good. I don't mean Messi. I mean the team as a whole. I mean, Ansu Fati and Ilyx Moriba are going to be like hard carrying that team because everybody else is just old and bad except for Messi. And you know, Suarez is starting to fade. His output's not, I mean, he's still better than the rest of the team. Guys, we've already qualified. Holy. We have already qualified for the final phase with 4 matches left. Now we're just playing to win the phase. We have already qualified for the final phase. We've won 12 of our 16 matches in this. This is insane. Oh, Dion. I forgot Dion. That's my bad. Dion is also, I don't think Dion is bad. But the team, old bad. Suarez back to Ajax. I heard that Suarez wanted to stay. Right? I heard that he wanted to stay. I don't know if they wanted him to stay. This is the fact. I mean, this is an amazing. This is where we finished last phase. The first half of this season, we finished eighth. And we got to eighth on the final day by winning the match against the team that was in eighth. And we backdoored the top eight to get to the semifinals. We qualified for the semifinals with four matches to go. Now we are playing to win the phase. That is why we play the game. Sensu, can you just send me that in a DM? I don't know if I have the time to break it down right now, but I'd love to. I would. So send it to me in a DM. Romania's finest. Whoa! Bacon!
Seven.
Mike, thank you so much for the seven. You're an absolute legend. But my boy Peter, who's Romania's finest, just got gold bacon. Chat, we need to get some bacon out in the chat. Romania's finest, I know him in real life. Fantastic dude. I told him I was streaming a year ago. He stayed strapped and subscribed ever since. A year. Gold bacon. There are less than 10 people on the planet that have gold bacon. Peter's one of them. Romania's finest. He is indeed Romania's finest. Thank you. And remember,
I simp for Zealand.
Hell yeah, we do. Thank you, man. And Mike, I mean, Mike's one of the top all-time sub gifters in the history of the channel with his 7 months. This bacon's out there for you too. A whole lot of
bacon
everywhere. It's just raining. It's raining. It's pouring. And Galvan, like, just wheezing injured. Yerson Candelo's back in the team though. That's great. We got Yerson Candelo back out there. Thank you. Thank you both, you guys. Peter, we'll talk soon. Gold bacon, an elusive golden bacon crown. Elusive. You want to marry me? Well, a lot of logistical problems with the pandemic and everything. Bit challenging. Truth is, I don't know how to stop, but keep... Peter, that doesn't surprise me somehow. Keep on, keep it up, keep going. Let's get this bag. Peter's over here like, dude, I'm totally trying to be your first groupie, so. You know what? Absolutely. I'm down for that, Peter. How's you, mate? How's life? Well, it was a lot better 5 seconds ago before Deportivo Pasta scored on us. A freaking back and forth flick header from Ibarguen. Their only shot of the opening 15 minutes. They bamboozled us. There you go, Sergio. Just terrible ball. Terrible ball. Very terrible. Didn't force the defense to move. If you're going to hit a clearance like that where you got a little time, you want to force the defense to move. Now we've given up two goals. That's okay. We've done this before. We went down 2-0 earlier in the season. We came back to win 3-2, and it was very similar. It was their first two shots. Weirdly enough, it is their first two shots again. We're going to hit it with a demand more. We're going to go into attack. We're going to go into attacking. We are going to move Julian Bray up. All the way up. You're pressing forward. You're an advance forward. Umanya comes up. He is a deep lying playmaker on defend, and Casado becomes a Metsala on attack. And this is how we're going to play. Let's go get our goals back. It's okay. We've done this once before. We came back. You keep your head down. You do exactly what you need to do to put yourself in a position to win. We've got Yerson Candelo back. We've got a lot. We have more offensive creativity on the field than we've had in a long time. We go to our more offensive formation. We're going to go get some goals. We know we're good enough to do this. We haven't created the chances so far. That's why we're further up the field. All right, Johnny, you can take this guy to the cleaners. I know you. I know you can. That's a shame. Somebody stop Ibarguen, please. Is he messy? Like, he's just gliding through everybody.
Let's get one before the half here. Get one before the half. Good throw. Get a good throw. That's pretty good, actually. Corner? All right. Yeah, we got a corner. Shoot. Oh, carry. In the corner. Nice tackle. All right. At least we're creating highlights now. Oh, ref. That's a red. He's by him. He's going, Max. God, he almost scored though, too. How do you get the body language on? You need to change your text size in preferences interface. Change your text size. Stats always behind cam? Yeah. So I can lie to you. I'm serious. So I can lie to you about the chances. No, I just think I want to be able to say the stats, but putting it over here, I feel like I block too much of the screen. So we see, you can see the stats like between highlights and stuff. We thought about the form. Oh, that was a red, dude. To me, it's a red. He's in. Bray is in. Right there, he's by everybody. There's no, like, he's going to be able to get two touches. That's denial of a clear, an obvious goal-scoring opportunity. You're going to tell me that was the same as the other one? Because that's what you just judged. You just judged that they were the same thing. They're the same level of infraction. Okay. They're not. I'm making my case, ref. Are you listening? Yerson Candelo comes back from an injury, has a 6.1 in the first half. Maybe we rushed you back a little too much, bud. Sorry about that. Been unlucky so far. Hey, no, except for you. I'm not. Okay, he's still switched off. I just coddled you and yelled at you. What do you want from me? What's your problem? All right, we can do this. We just need... that team talk was not bad. This team just loves to break, dude. What a tackle. Go! We're behind them. There were like five of them up the field. There we go. Let's go. We went. Don't you know? It's Johnny Cano. Best player on the team. Johnny Cano. 20 goals this season. Bag it. Get some nerves popping back up top of formation here. Don't like that. Man, they hit that counter. They get these numbers up, man. We can counter them hard. Good block. Discipline defending. That's all. That's it. How do you say your tactics against a team that parks the bus? You do this. And I mean, if they're really parked, you get a guy up here too. But you want two strikers. You want two advanced wingers. You want people up against them all the time. I have a lot of experience in this match engine going against park buses because I played in Belarus and won the Champions League. So league matches were a bit of a blowout. Come on, boys. We've given ourselves a lot of time here. We've outshot, outchanced, and outpossessed them. Oh, did he pick him out here? Get a little flick? Nah, wrong decision, Miguel. Good thing we've got the best goalkeeper in the division. Keep us steady at the back here. Are you picking out? Oh, Julian. I didn't blame Julian for that. I think Diarmas can get to that. Sato, good pass. Cano. Oh. Too cheeky. Somebody's offside, too. Too cheeky. Come on, guys. I need a little more. Can't fall into a malaise. We haven't even gotten into a draw yet. There we go. Oh, don't take that touch. Turn with the touch. Looking to break. Maybe I need to turn the tempo up.
Need to turn the tempo up so that he does turn, so that he does look to push. Starball again. Good. Back to Lemus. Lemus picks about, picks somebody out. There we go. Somebody somewhere. They're not pushing. They're not pushing on the counter. Any. Oh my god, dude. No reason to jump in there. He's on a tight angle, and you'll probably be able to block the shot, but it's okay because it's Ebargwin, and he can do no wrong today. All right, Bruce, thank you for bringing a fantastic mod, as always. Yeah, my passing is short. I don't want to go direct. I mean, are you watching Medina and Brea? Are you watching Medina and Brea try to win these balls? I don't want to go direct, dude. Salute the mod. He's off. Shoot. This, I really thought we were going to be able to get this back to a draw. Now I'm not sure. Sorry, Scafati's not a normal starter. Missing Moschetta. We're missing Moschetta. He's out with a card suspension. So, that's unfortunate. We need another sub. We're going to take Johnny Cano and put him over for Miguel Medina. We're going to play him as a deep lying forward on attack. And then we're going to take off Miguel Medina and put in Luis Eduardo Vidal. Complete wing backs on attack so that they can cut in as well. They've got the ability to... They've got a little more creative agency as complete wing backs. I do not have really any more super offensive subs. Jair Hernandez is a really technical guy we can bring in. Harsh 3-1 right now. Cash their first two shots in. Sorry, the mindset of the team's fluctuating wildly, but it's still, for the most part, capable of getting us goals. The other reason for short is that my midfielders are my two best players. What is that tackle attempt? So you get the ball into them, and then they can look to pick the pass out. That was just really good play. I think I'm too mad about that. Jairo Umana is frustrated. All right, we'll go Jair Hernandez. Put him on support. So might as well get the fresh legs out there now, right? Hopefully they can knock it down for the midfield. Come on, gentlemen. Oh, he's off. I thought that was a red card challenge. Are we just going to ignore that? That was a scissor kick. Okay, I'm fine with that. I'm glad we paid the ref enough. Beautiful. 1-1. Okay, good, good. Exactly how we drew it up. Yes, beautiful. Come on, chat. Here we go. We're doing it again. Cardiac Genettos. The Swampers, they leave it late, chat. Valko, bacon! Thank you so much for the 2 months of the Prime, Valko. You're 1 month away from cooking that bacon, and more importantly, you spent Jeff Bezos money to get here. Great ball from DeArmas. Jair Hernandez throwing himself into the box with those fresh legs, gets the goal. Come on, why are we still freaking nervous, man? Let's get creative. All right? Inspirational stuff. You serious? Serious right now? Okay. Okay. Let's go, gentlemen. Oh, here we go. Long throw for 3-3. I'm in danger. That's cool. Okay, that is a good run. Mother! God, we gave up 4 goals. That's like by 2 the most we've given up all year. Obviously, the fourth one's because we're just throwing the kitchen sink at him. Well, that's our third loss of the phase. And unlucky, boys. I've been putting too much pressure on him recently. I think that's why we cracked early. It's the second match in a row that we'd started with a few nervous players, and that was my fault. I had not assuaded that. We were kind of unlucky, especially to give up a goal on their first two shots there. So, hey! I know, I'm back. Bruh. No, I had not, the internet has nothing to do with the save. Drives me absolutely insane. Absolutely insane. I like no logic to it. Hadn't happened in a week and a half, and then all of a sudden the internet just drops for like 3 seconds. When it does that, OBS is like, dude, you gotta restart your computer. I have no idea. And I'm like, it drives me insane. I've got to figure out what causes that, because that's the second time that's happened. It's happened like once a week. No, once every 2 weeks. It didn't happen at all last week. Like once every 6 streams or something. It just drops. Like no internet for 3 seconds. And then you have to reset OBS completely. And I'm like, dude, I don't care if you give me a bit a second, if you keep it on, we're good. I have no idea. It doesn't. The reason it's maddening, right, is I have another computer. Obviously, we have two computers. The other one is right here. It does not happen on this computer. It only happens on this computer. So you folk of the internet, if you have any ideas, let me know. It's not part of the school setup at all. No, I'm off the campus. No, I mean, it's like a little bit of both, clearly. I don't know if it's... I'm trying to send a lot of information through the net. Well, I've had a bunch of different theories. But to be honest, like the last 4 streams... That didn't happen, and I was like, oh, okay, I guess we're just good. And it happened again. And I was like, new cable. I mean, the cable is like attached to the antenna thing. There's no cable. And we just lost. Proper rage quit. Is it the apartment? Like, do you have a roommate who also loses internet? Well, I mean, my roommate's not trying to stream, you know. Because if you lose internet on Netflix for a few seconds, it doesn't matter. Right? It doesn't matter. But it was Renteria that was suspended. It wasn't Mosqueda. Mosqueda just got suspended. About to get back-to-back promotion. I'm doing well. Congratulations, mummies. Thanks for all the help. Oh, you did all the hard work. I promise you, you did all the hard work. Maybe get a hard wire to the router instead. There is none. We've had this conversation and you must have missed it. And now I'm going back into the treasure trove of why I'm so frustrated and why no one should ever live at Copper Beach Commons ever. And I don't give a flop if they hear that. Because they just flat out lied to me about the internet. and there's no Ethernet. They lied to me until I'd paid them $4,000, and then they're like, oh yeah, it's a Wi-Fi only building, but we've never had complaints about the internet. And I'm over here like, do you even understand what I'm doing with the internet? Do you? No, you fools. No, Alva, you're good. But that's just where I needed to go. That's where we needed to go. They had no idea. Clearly not, but no idea. I'm just like, I am paying you with the internet. Patience, there are no plans to provide the club with any investment at this stage. The takeover is still ongoing. Board lift transfer embargo. Yay. Oh, Jose Sanchez did buy the... Oh, shit. Mother f***er is... What? What is a service hanging? I don't know what that is. How'd I get into FM content? I just really enjoyed playing the game, and so I realized I had time to stream and wanted to say that. That'd be good. Did you try bridging the internet from one to the other? Suppose I could. Wouldn't that be make it worse though than it already is? Like the quality would be worse than it already is. When is the new face pack? FM21. Do you think Neymar will score tonight? Yes. Now the transfer embargo has been lifted. Maybe you can trial some more players. No, I know I can go back and get the trial of the players. We just had a takeover. Just like unnecessary to local investor Jose Sanchez has completed his takeover. Genaro succeeding former president Hector Mateus. He's keen to get stuck into the new role as soon as possible. There's no update. They still absolutely adore me. The embargo is lifted, and that's it. Okay. The club has a new owner, and now we're playing the second team in the league for the second time in 2 weeks. Yeah, it checks out. But I do think Neymar will score tonight. Wi-Fi auto changes channel and client drops from the network. Can I do anything about that, Keck? No investment. Balance, I don't think, changed at all. I think they just maintained they maintained the exact same stuff. Just a local and just a changing of the guard. No change on my end. My score predictions, well, we'll have to see that on AllCod stream, huh? We're raiding over there in like 20 minutes. But yeah, Keck, people that know about the internet stuff, Keck and Ben, if you guys could elaborate on what you were talking about. I'm very, very interested. But Neymar, I think Neymar scores tonight because if PSG is going to win, I think Neymar's probably got to score or he's got to set up a play. He has to be the catalyst for PSG winning the game, right? Like he's got to be the dude. Can you log into the Wi-Fi router? No. Yeah, I'm using a wireless transmitter. Assuming right now you have both boxes on their own wireless transmitter. Instead, you have a wireless receiver. You connect both boxes through Ethernet. So if I plug the streaming computer into the gaming computer, the computer through the Ethernet port on both computers, it will transfer the Wi-Fi from this computer. And so the fact that for some reason that I don't know that the Wi-Fi just drops on this computer for a few seconds, then I'll be able to just go around that and it'll be fine. And maybe I pick up a little latency, but who cares? That's awesome. Will you be showing the game with James or just talking about it? We will be like we'll be a panel of pundits watching the game, providing commentary on the game. That is what will be happening. But we can't show the game. I mean, that's wildly illegal. So we can't show the game, but we will be watching the YouTube stream of the game. So we, you know, and if you want to watch, we can watch the YouTube stream of the game, and we will be providing our commentary, not, you know, Clive commentary, but our commentary on the game. I think it's going to be fantastic. I'm really excited for it. How does overall balance work? Why does it never match the changes in any other number in finances? Overall balance is how much money the club has. I mean, how much money are they spending on everything from traveling to and from away games to... You know, how much money you're spending on salary and staff salary, and how much money is coming in from everything, you know, from fees for friendlies to sales of players. That's it. Darren thinks whoever scores first tonight's going to win. You're restarting your computer to fix the problem. Yeah, dude. It's something. Something's miss. I'll be living it up on Google, trying to figure out what it is, what might exactly be causing that just quick drop. It's free to air on YouTube, yes. The game is free on YouTube. And if it's not, then James Lawrence Alcott lied to me. And I think we can all agree that James Lawrence Alcott is not a guy that lies to people. Ronald Hernandez, Venezuelan fullback. I'll spend the money. We just had a takeover. We're flush with cash. Just kidding. Flush with cash. All right, Deportes Tolima. Get ready to get played. I'm a Brit in Poland. My struggle to find how to view it is very real. It's not on YouTube. Oh, no. Is it possible to do that by sharing the connection as a bridge? It is hanky, but it works. You can Google network bridge to learn more about it. All right. Maybe that's the way to go about it. I think it might just be easier to figure out why the computer just drops the internet for a second. Now we can figure that out. I'm a man of the world. A man of technology and intelligence. Good joke. Okay. Hey, RJ Trey.
Bacon.
Thank you so much for the Prime. Thank you so much for the 2 months of spending Jeff Bezos money here. I appreciate that a ton. Thank you. Thank you for your 2 months. Oh, my goodness.
Bacon.
Jeff Bezos, he's losing his cash. It's over. We're going to put Bezos in a bankruptcy. Keck Miterno has spent some Bezos bucks. The Twitch Prime. Amazing. Outstanding. A spiritual performance. The team is distraught after that loss. Mentally, we're in a hole right now. What was that? Dude, I mean, like, we're on this incredible win streak, I guess, but... There we go! Yes! Oh, hype train, baby. Let's go.
Bacon.
Paul Glassy with the Twitch Prime as well. Jeff Bezos. He's paying for the hammers, really. He's bankrolling the hammers just like that. Did you see that team talk? Come on. Did you see that team talk? Welcome to the Hammers, to Polg and Keck and RJ Trey. Welcome back. Polglossy HD. I thought I did okay. How lay it on me. How am I supposed to say it? We're missing it. Okay, we're missing this too. We got to pick out somebody else that can come and play on the bench today. It should be Dylan Barrero, and we don't want to get rid of a center back. So we get Scafati. And Barrero, Hernandez, De Armas, and Vidal. Johnny Cano, Miguel Medina, Yerson Candelo, who had a terrible match. really terrible match last time he took the field, but now we're at home against Deportes Tolima. Let's go get 3 points from this last two matches. Nice, composed finish to the season. That's what we're looking for. Nailed it. The game's on CBS Sports Network too, not just CBS All Access. Pole Glaze. Okay. Pole Glaze. I tend to just go frenetic. We get people from all around the world, so I just go frenetic and hope for the best. Pole Glaze. Or was the first one the one that nailed it? And we're just doomed. The five sub rule is killing me in this league, though. I'm addicted to having a sub that can play every position so that I can survive players getting hurt, right? Always. But you just can't do that sometimes when you get in this position. You only have five subs and you just want to have tactical options because you're much more likely to have to use the tactical options to try and win the game. All right, Yerson, here we go. We are top of the league by a point with a match in hand. That match in hand is against Deportes Tolima. This could really cause a problem. Eusebio with the prime in the 2 months.
Bacon
for Eusebio. Welcome back to the Hammers and that Jeff Bezos cash money. Thank you for spending it here. Oh, I mean, being able to bring on five players is what he was talking about. Yeah, I think they might keep that. I think they might keep the bringing on five players. I mean, the game's always moved to being able to make more changes as the game goes on. So that's you already start seeing in stats that refer to like minutes played instead of games played now. Yeah. Hey, what's up? Do you guys reckon I can get a left-footed player to work as a winger on the right side? I guess it will affect his crossing, but I'm willing to sacrifice that. Could he still theoretically... That's inverted winger. Just play him as an inverted winger. He'll do the same thing. He'll pick the ball up, and then he'll cut back inside to his inside foot and look to get the ball back in across. That's what he's looking to do. Eusebio, thank you again. 1 month from that cooked bacon, that crispy, popping on the pan, cooked bacon. Enjoy the match today. Well, do enjoy the match today. Do enjoy the match today. And that pushed us into level 2 of high. We completed level 1 on a hype train for the second time today. What's going on, kids of gaming? How you doing? All right, this is a big match. We want to finish top of the phase in the top flight. This is a big match. Get in. Hey! Oh, this is a spot. This is a spot. It wasn't even a great service. Did he make a save there? Okay, so here we go. We got a chance. That's where you lost it. You got to go back to the corner. You can get a second cross in real quick. Nice composure by that guy. Just chew it. Bacon. Welcome to the Hammers with Eusebio, Pole Glaze, Kekmeturdo. I mean, everybody, we just scored a goal, and that's all because...
Bacon.
Of this hype train going on right now and all of the...
Bacon.
Yes! Jose Luis Casado! Oh, that team talk was huge. That was really probably the best team talk of my... the best team talk of my FM20 career. We completely turned it around. What a block. Completely turned it around. We were really devastated at the end of a win streak, but I had to go back and remind the boys that we were playing out of our skins, so far above expectation after just getting promoted last season. That, you know, now the fact that we're digging in and we're really competing for a phase title here, it means a lot. Shows a lot. What's the new schedule? It's already been changed. I changed it live. So if you look at the Twitch schedule function or the Stream Elements schedule function down below, you will see our new 4-week schedule that we always... Okay. Far from over the match, far from over. We've outchanced them though and outpossessed them. So we just keep going. Expect to score multiple goals, even though we really are starting to bleed a few goals now. Starting to bleed a little bit at the back. I know we're playing good teams, but... That was a little free. What do you mean phase? Yeah, there's an 18 playoff. The season is broken into two phases. You play phase one, phase two. There's a winner that's crowned of each phase, right? You go to the playoff, and then if you win the semifinals, and then the final of the playoff, the semifinals are 2 4-team groups. Then you have a chance to compete for the league title. So we are putting ourselves in the best position possible by winning the regular season of the phase. That would have been one of those crosses that was going in. But welcome, Sasha. But everybody that subscribed, Chewit, Polglaze, Keck, make sure you get in the subscriber section of the Discord to hang out with, you know, Eusebio, RJ. They're in there. I did have a takeover. Nothing changed. Local businessman. I just couldn't trial people for a few months, so it ruined my trial farm of, like, potential backups. A lot of highlights. Creative game for us going forward. Very creative game. I like this. How do you set a tactic against a park bus? Two strikers, two wings, two center mids, four at the back. That's my preferred way to go at a parked bus. Darren, you can ignore my tips. I mean, I'm not the end-all be-all. I don't profess to be the greatest football manager player on the face of the earth. But I do play the game a lot. I'm sorry that happened to you, though. I would love for you to prove me wrong on the selling players at 22. Because once they hit 22, and if they're not looking like they're going to be a fairly regular feature in the first team, it's probably time to sell them for profit because you'll still get good money for them. Play him! Why are you shooting then, man? Why are you shooting then? Why are you shooting then? Dude. Hi, I am a new breakthrough prospect of the chat. Havik, that's exactly the type of mentality we're looking for. Does it change anything? No, you get a little bump in revenue, like merch revenue, Sasha. But other than that, no, I don't think it changes anything. That's cool, though. It's never happened for me. Dude coming out on my team, it's like free money. Because they sell more merchandise. When you look at it from like a, how does this affect the way your game is playing out? In a social way, it's really cool that they added it to the game, right? We're not doing badly. I mean, I don't want to come out and say like we're dominating because Ketia Curry's having a bad game. But we could do more. Julian Bray, particularly, could do more. He's been very influential from midfield at points this season, and he's not doing anything for us right now from there. Oh, the passion is starting to stir. The passion is starting to stir. Dude! Come on. We need one moment. We can really put ourselves in a position to win the whole phase. Hit it! And it just... Not putting it together in that final third. We're all over it with the highlights right now. We're just not putting it together in the final third. Again with the chance. We are just not putting it together in the final third. Driving me nuts today. The double attacking. Yeah, we already have him on that. We started the game in the double attacking. All right, where are you going to hit me from? What's your move? Oh, nice take. Got to hit it towards the circle, though. What a play. Pressing forward extraordinaire Miguel Medina. Yeah, well, he's not expected to know what to do once he gets up there. He's just supposed to take the ball away. He didn't have a clear path. He was very confused. He's not used to defenders in his way when he has the ball. It's madness out there. Oh, this is the moment. It's long throw cheese. He's got a guy to the left of him. He found him. Great recovery. Wow. Anderson Mojica, fabulous fullback play. Wind sprints up the field 70 minutes in. Not defending this poorly. Oh my goodness, what a defensive display from Anderson Mojica on two occasions. Medina, he's all alone. Oh! Was that a dribble move? Football Manager, was this a dribble move? Was this a dribble move? Kind of. Not really. I thought he gave him a little bit more than that. Dude, nice moves, though. Even if the match engine didn't show it, nice moves. I want more. I want the step overs. You know, I want the fancy dribble moves in the game. Miguel Medina just dusted him off. Okay, you didn't think Miguel Medina had it in him. I, on the other hand, believed the whole time. Gotta leave Julian Bray in there, man. Gotta leave Julian Bray in there. We'll bring in Dylan Barrero because he is an inside forward and that could be fun. Switch these guys up so Julian Bray doesn't get in the way of our inside forward who's now on the field, and Barrero, who coming back from an injury just like Yerson Candelo. Is he gonna make the difference? Come on, cardiac Genetos again. So many winners in the last 10 minutes of matches this year. We're looking for another one. Oh man, he got destroyed on that header. Very roundly destroyed on that header. Not a great chance for them, but God. What do you think of the underutilized position? What the most underutilized position and role? Well, position's hard to say. People use, you know, positions everywhere. Like all the positions are used. But I think maybe the most underutilized role is do people use a lot of pressing forwards? Pressing forwards are good. Like Raheem Sterling's a pressing forward. You play FM11, they had a spam of skill moves. I loved it. No, I didn't, but I'm sad I missed it. Why'd they remove it? Hazy, what do you think of complete forwards? They're great, but they're not the best forward for every situation. Advanced forwards for me can be better than complete forwards, but that's really the only one. A lot of people use pressing forwards. Okay. Then I think Rom Deuter. I don't think a lot of people use Rom Deuters, and I use Rom Deuters to get players on the field on the wing all the time. Just to get players on the field on the wing, I will use a Rom Deuter. A draw in this situation is fine, which is why I'm not going to completely sell out for the 3 points like I normally would. This is the team in second in the league at the moment. Get a cross in. Oh, it's there! They are must to win the phase! They are must to win the phase! Ah, yes. I will conquer you. You will be mine, Colombia. You. Boom! Cardiac Genetos again. Very well could have just won the phase for the boys. Very well could have just won the phase for Genetos. Baby! Andres De Armas off the bench. A genius little sub right there at the end. Gave him an opportunity, and my goodness, did he take it, ladies and gentlemen. My goodness, did he take it. Now you go over here. Like how I'm sorting this just to make it absolutely perfect. No, you go over here. It'll be nice. Just go right there and yeah.
Woo! Baby!
Yes!
Andres de Armas from Julian Brea.
Very well taken. 6th goal of the season. All right, let's see this out. We got the pause in before we started the celebration. Let's kill the rest of the game off, okay, guys? Get our defense back for this corner. Hey, nice header. That'll do. Anywhere will do. There in particular, nice choice, Dixon. Very good choice. Yes, wins us the phase, dude. If we hold on to this result, the only team that can get to 41 points is Atletico Nacional, and we have to lose our last match. They have to win their last two, and they have to make up 14 goal difference. This would win us the phase if we hold this result, because the other results around the league, we would win the phase before going to watch the Champions League with James. Take your time, man. Take your time. Thank you, FM gods. An American declaring Colombia is his. The optics, not great. The context, okay. Sorry. You gotta watch the game out here? No, I'm going over to James. I'm a pundit on James Lawrence Alcott's stream, but it looks like, ladies and gentlemen, we are, Yep. Yippers. Yep. Yeah. Uh-huh. Gary, what do you think? To give Chelsea a place in the Champions League final. The headline has been written.
With the winner, a little party for winning the regular season. We're headed to the playoffs is the number one overall seed in those playoffs. Does this send you to the Copa Libertadores or Sudamerica? I have no freaking idea. We don't know. It's too hard to figure out, and we tried, but it certainly might. And we will just continue celebrating that fact. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to raid James Lawrence Alcott. It is time to raid. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. Thank you for all the subs and the hype trains. And welcome to everybody that's in the hammers. Darren, what do you want me to say? We got to get out of here in a hot second.
We have a personal message going out to Darren real quick before we head off. Glasgow is green and white.
Personal message redeemed. Darren, I see you out there rapping that Celtic. All right. Next stream is Tuesday. New schedule is out. Check it out here. Check it out in the Stream Elements little widget thing down below. We are watching the Champions League final with James Lawrence Alcott. I am part of his punditry. His punditry. All right, we're headed over. We're going to go jump in on him. All right, James. I will see you guys over there. Have a great rest of your day. Thank you for everybody that's a part of the Hammers that allows me to do what I do and allows me to hang out with you guys all the freaking time. 3 YouTube videos a week, I believe, starting this week. I haven't heard for sure from Reese or able to get it going this week, but I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, that's something to watch out for. Headed over to James. I will see you guys over there. My final prediction, ESG. My final score, 3-2. Come from behind, win. Neymar goal, Neymar assist. That's what I'm thinking. All right, Champions League final. Next, James Lawrence Alcott stream. Let's go.